We've come up with several theories, including wind propulsion, some sort of gravity suspension effect, also the possibility that the clouds pull the plane skyward, but you know, beyond that, just don't understand how a large metal tube could just kind of float in the air like that. And it's going at like 500 miles per hour, which means that when I'm on a plane, I'm also going 500 miles per hour. I mean, that's crazy. I mean, why is my hair blowing back and forth?
The Stanford team added they plan to devote the next 2 years to a new study on why telephones can hear. In other news, an urban planner is stuck in traffic of his own design, and a kid screams behind a passenger during an entire plane crash. Visit theonion.com/newsbeat for more.
Welcome to Free Talk Live. You dial toll-free if you want. Join us on the radio waves here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Joining you in studio tonight, you've got me, Ian.
Cantwell.
And Mark.
And, of course, you can join us online. Just drop on by freetalklive.com. And do enjoy the features waiting for you. You can get interactive with other Free Talk Live listeners. Submit content right there to the front page via our Reddit-based system. And then that allows you to vote on whether or not you like or dislike what other people have submitted to the site. So go there, get interactive at freetalklive.com. Chris Cantwell, it has been a busy, busy last few days for you. You've been, I guess, propelled to the front lines of New Hampshire media to some extent with a video that came out that you made. You didn't really want to make this video, but ultimately you had to due to the situation you found yourself in a few nights ago here in Keene. And I believe you talked about this on the air previously on, was it Freedom Fiends? Where did you discuss this already?
Yeah, it may come as a shock to some of the audience that I was on Freedom Fiends. And I had been on the porch and I heard Derek talking about the incident. And so I went inside and shared the story with Derek, who was at the moment hosting Freedom Fiends.
Is that the only place you've talked about it, or did you do an episode of your show since?
I did an episode of Radical Agenda where we talked about it, yeah.
Okay, so Radical Agenda, which is available over at ChristopherCantwell.com. So therefore, it hasn't really been broached, I don't think, on Free Talk Live as of yet. Let's recap. You've been actually hanging out here a lot, because you've been sort of playing security guard on the LRN.FM front porch, and we can talk about the reason why here in a moment. But there have been some thefts and some vandalism that have gone on here. And you were leaving late one night, walking back to your home here in Keene, New Hampshire, going through the downtown area, and you encountered some women who appeared to be in distress.
Yes, I hear crying female voices and angry yelling male voices. And I decide that I will go and investigate, as I frequently do when I sense that there is trouble afoot. I go around with a camera and I try to record it. They were not so hot on being recorded, surprisingly.
None of them were. The women did not like being recorded, and the men did not like. What was it? Four people?
Yeah, there were two men and two women.
And they told you to stop recording them.
They certainly did. The only thing, though, is I did not value highly the advice of drunk, irrational people who I sensed might be on the verge of a dangerous, violent conflict. Mm-hmm. I think that those opinions should certainly be discounted. When one thinks that a situation might erupt in violence, the people who are about to engage in that violence are not good sources of advice, shall we say. And so I refused to stop recording them, and they attempted to attack me.
They also whipped out the justification that what you're doing was illegal. I recall that from the video. They were advising you of the legality of videotaping them.
I love how everybody turns into a lawyer right before they lose their minds. Right, like it's something that happens all the time. I've got another video up on YouTube where I recorded a phone call in New York, and it's actually now the second most popular video that I've ever recorded was me firing an employee. And you'd say like at least 50% of the negative comments are saying that I'm going to go to jail for doing this, while New York is a one-party consent state. It happens all the time that people think they know what the law is, but it's usually right before they completely freak out.
Well, the law is a justification for freaking out, right? Like, I'm in the right, so I can behave badly.
Right. The legislature justified my violence.
Indeed.
Yeah. So, and we've seen this before as well. Derek J has been threatened for recording video, and the same claims are made that it's illegal. You can't record me without my consent. And
right, and it caused him to be assaulted outside of the courthouse. It got JP assaulted. JP just wound up in the hospital not so long ago. I've seen video of Garrett being attacked in the city. And hey, guys, I got a gun. Not gonna fly.
So you were approached and in a very aggressive manner by these people after they yelled at you from across the street. It looked like you were in the median area of Main Street. Is that right?
I was on the center divide just by pure happenstance. That's where I was when I heard the voices. And so I walked on the center divide towards the sound of the conflict.
They were yelling at you, and your motivation seemed to be, hey, it looked like these women were in danger. It looked like something was going on. They were crying, right? So something was wrong.
I've got an instinct that when I hear women crying and men yelling at them, that I'm supposed to do something about that.
Yeah.
I can tell you that generally it isn't going to go well. That in most cases... In most cases, the couple that is has a dispute really doesn't want anyone else involved, whether or not they should have somebody involved. I guess.
Yeah. No. If she wants to be the victim of a domestic assault in the privacy of her own home, by all means, she's free to do that. But I see it going on in public. I feel compelled to go and see what's the matter.
Even when it's when women or men do call the police, oftentimes they wish they hadn't, because then the couple's going through court trying to work it out and all that stuff.
Yeah, and this is sort of one of the criticisms which I should have put in the article that I just published about it, is that people say, well, why didn't you call the police? Well, I don't want to call the police. I don't want these people to get in trouble. I'm just trying to make sure that nobody gets hurt. Calling the police is a massive escalation of this conflict that could have somebody going to jail, and that's the last thing I wanted. I didn't want to bring any harm to these people, and I certainly didn't want to get the police involved. So
somebody called them, though, right?
Well, somebody called them, all right, after they heard me pull out my gun and tell them to stay the F away from me.
You think it was one of the four who called the police?
No, they did not call the police. There was no time for
that.
Were
there observers, there were witnesses?
I was quite loud. I did not see any bystanders on the street. Mm-hmm.
This was like, what, 3 in the morning?
Yeah, it was around 3 o'clock in the morning.
Could have been somebody. I mean, the people live up there.
Yeah,
that's true.
One of the YouTube commenters said, oh, so this is what woke me up last night. So it seems like somebody in town was woken up by my terrified, angry voice. And decided that 911 would be a good option. And I'll tell you what, I am glad that they did.
Well, I want to talk more about the police and how that worked out, because I think that was one of the more interesting parts of this situation, and it was a surprise to you as well. You told me later on, had this been anywhere besides New Hampshire, you may have likely been a dead man after just trying to defend yourself and protect yourself from being harmed by these psychopaths who were on who knows what as they were coming at you. But let's go to your phone calls and thoughts. You can bring up anything. We've got Vincent in Seattle, Washington. Vincent, you're on Free Talk Live. The Ian, Chris Cantwell, and Mark.
Hi, Ian. This is, you just introduced me. So,
yes, sir.
I just wanted to thank Chris Cantwell for not dying last night. That would have been really,
this was a few nights ago,
really kind of detrimental to my YouTube, watching experience. But I actually called about last night when you were talking about solar roadways.
Yeah, so what we mentioned last night, Mark, you had a story about these solar roadways that are actually in test run in Norway, was it?
It was Netherlands.
The Netherlands. And they have a bicycle path that's 700 meters, was it, or 70 meters? Anyway, it's fairly short.
Yeah, 70 meters, like 250 feet.
But they say these things are working better than they expected.
Yeah, I basically am kind of a skeptic of these things, mostly because... As efficient as solar panels can ever get, they can only ever put out as much light and the bike lane markings as the paint would reflect. So they kind of seem like a really big government boondoggle to me.
Now, I don't understand what you're saying about the paint would reflect. What is that all about?
Basically, when light comes into contact with a solar panel, you can convert some of it into electricity. And then the idea of the solar roadways that I saw was that you can then run LEDs on the hexagonal panels with that power.
And that's right.
Project either a bike lane or a pedestrian lane or even a car lane. And that way you can use the road more ideally. But
right, so you're using LEDs embedded in the road itself to have like turning indicators or something like that. You know, when you come up on an intersection, you get
the
right turn arrow that would be inside the road rather than painted on top.
It could flash and let you know what lane you're in. That way, you know, people who might be in the wrong lane can move over.
I'm not sure what you're saying is the issue with having LED lights inside the road. I'm not clear on that. So, Vincent, hang on. We'll come back here in a moment so you can explain it to me. 855-450-FREE, and you can bring up anything here on Free Talk Live.
There are two types of advertising. Pull advertising, like Google AdWords, where a consumer goes looking for widgets near them and you try to pull them in with your ad away from the other widget purveyors. Then there's push advertising, where you push your message out about your great widgets and attempt to convince people who weren't thinking about widgets at all that what they need in their life right now is your widget. Radio is push advertising. In the course of a week, there are probably over 250,000 good folks listening to Free Talk Live, and they could hear your message. We're having a sale right now, and it ends May 15th. 200 30-second ads for $1,997. That's like 10 bucks an ad. Find another show with that kind of rate with 150-plus stations. Email me, markedge @freetalklive.com, and I'll set you up. You don't need to have an ad. We'll produce it for you. Buy 200 30-second ads by May 15th and get them for less than $10 a piece. It's a big savings, and you don't want to miss it. Email me, mark @freetalklive.com. Now,
on the average, Americans work between 45 to 50 years, hoping to build up enough wealth to retire and live out their golden years. Unfortunately, with taxation, the rising cost of food, energy, housing, and medical, many retirees are forced to live below the poverty line. Is this a flaw of free enterprise, or is our monetary unit we call the Federal Reserve Note forcing us into perpetual debt, ensuring inflation and higher taxes? These questions and more can be answered by reading G. Edward Griffin's book, The Creature from Jekyll Island. Congressman Ron Paul states it's what every American needs to know about central bank power. A gripping adventure into the secret world of international banking cartel. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. I will give a silver dollar from the early 1900s to anyone who purchases this book. Call 1-800-686-2237 and order a copy today. It's critical that the public be made aware of the system. Call and order your copy today at 1-800-686-2237. That's 1-800-686-2237.
Are you looking for an excuse to come check out New Hampshire this fall? You're invited to Keenevention. Keenevention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Keenevention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenevention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year's keynote speeches and panels will be announced via the Keenevention blog and Facebook, so stay tuned there for the list. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenevention this October 30th through November 1st. Tickets are available now at a special early bird price of just $50 via credit card or Bitcoin. That $50 price only lasts through the end of June, so don't delay. Reserve your tickets now at keenevention.info. Visit keenevention.info for more and look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenevention.info. So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolf. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You're invited here to join us on the radio waves. So bring up whatever happens to be on your mind. Coming up, I was shocked to see this libertarian, this anarchist, self-described anarchist that we've had on this program, Jeff Berwick, has announced he is running for political office. And this was a shocker, and we'll talk more about that here in a little bit when we get a chance. Your calls, of course, are welcome, and our Skype username, by the way, if you'd like to call us that way, is username lrn.fm. With you in studio, you've got Ian,
Cantwell,
and Mark.
And Mark, please tell me about Fort Gault. What is it?
Well, Fort Gault is, I think it's best, we call it a little condominium community down in Chile. What they're doing is they're having Benson Wood, that's a big name in architecture, build a small complex of units. Now, these aren't going to be your average condominium units. Many of them are, I would call them micro units. The ones that are made for families are really just a large room. The ones that are made for individuals are quite small rooms, so far as to say a cell. And, you know, this is great because they have lots of communal spaces. And the intention is to get people who, you know, want to get away from the United States, who are entrepreneurs, who want to expose themselves to perhaps a less regulated marketplace, create ideas with other entrepreneurs, that they can all get together and collaborate in a space that's outside the U.S. And that's what they're doing down there in Chile at fortgault.com. It's a fresh, vibrant center of art, innovation, education, and creative capitalism.
This is the ground floor on this, right?
Very much so. And now, yeah, you don't have to put a whole bunch of money in to get involved. They actually ask you to just sort of make a commitment and then pay on a regular basis.
There's like stages or whatever.
Yeah, there's stages, four stages of payment. So, you know, not much of a risk as it goes by. FortGault.com to get involved.
All right, we're going to bring Vincent back on the line here. He says he's a critic of the so-called solar roadways, which, you know, when I heard about them, sounded pretty cool. The idea being that you got all this blacktop out there, miles and miles, thousands of miles, hundreds of thousands. I don't know how many miles of blacktop there are in the United States alone, but it's got to be a lot. And you've got all this blacktop just sitting out there soaking up the sun all day long everywhere. Why not turn that into a resource for powering things? Seems like it makes sense, if it can make economic sense, and that's, of course, the big question. And also, what about some of the other objections? And you're saying, Vincent, you've got some objections here, and one of the objections you were describing is, and I was very unclear, and so I wanted to make sure that we were able to clarify this. You seem to have some objection to the lighting that would work underneath the road, because the idea is that underneath the solar panel there are LED lights that can light up, be computer controlled to show like road indicators, you know, turn ahead, that kind of thing, lines on the road, that instead of having paint physically on the roadway, that there would be LEDs that would be powered by the solar power generated from the sunlight. So where is the objection with that? Because that seems to be sensible to me. LEDs don't take a lot of power to operate.
Well, normally the LEDs don't take a lot of power to operate, but when you're talking about simulating the amount of sunlight that white paint reflects, you're actually talking about more power than the solar roadway would be generating with the rest of the blacktop around it by, you know, significant margins.
Well, if that were the case, why would they be manufacturing this product? I mean, if the product couldn't even...
Well, I think that his complaint here is that, you know, roadways tend to be operated by governments.
True.
Governments are not averse to wasting money.
Right, but if what he's saying is that one panel of this road can't even sustain the LED lights that are within the panel, that just doesn't make sense.
Like, I don't know that LEDs are going to occupy more energy than a solar panel would create, but I do think that they would be draining a battery at night, and that is
something
that would be problematic. So, I mean, a solar panel is going to generate an enormous amount of energy during a hot day, but it's putting that energy likely into batteries beneath the Roadway, which are then going to have to power the LEDs throughout the course of the evening, and that I suspect might be troublesome.
Yeah, I can see that being the case. I mean, then you've got battery banks every so often along the road, and that, you know, those are going to have to be serviced, and how often do you have to replace those batteries?
Let's not forget that they clean solar panels. They try to keep them clean because, you know, just dust and water and stuff creates a film on them,
yeah,
and they
gets in the way. Yeah, reduces efficiency.
Reduces efficiency. In this case, we're talking about driving dirty cars with dirty tires across them. That's going to really reduce efficiency, and then plus whatever scrapes and scratches go on the roadway as a result, and that's really going to mess with things.
I think there are
it
some good
makes
objections.
Some more sense to make roads out of road stuff and make roofs out of solar panels. I don't know.
I think there are good objections to this technology, no doubt about it. But I think it's also interesting that at least it's being tried somewhere. And, you know, the only way we're going to know if this stuff works is to actually put it into effect and see how it goes, right?
Sure. And the technical problems are one aspect of this sort of plan. But there's always these unseen things whenever you get something that has a lot of hype around it, which is what I suspect is sustaining a lot of this type of innovation in the Nordic countries. And the sort of unseen would be the environmental consequences of making, as you said, thousands and millions of miles of silicon dioxide, basically doped microchips. And we're going to coat our entire highway system with microchip material.
Did this take place in the United States, or this was in some other country?
Well, the video sort of went viral on the internet, and then I believe Netherlands decided that they would try it. Now, they only tried 70 meters, 250 feet worth of bike path. That's their shot at it. Now, they're saying it's going better than expected, but what does that mean? I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, if I heard about this happening in the United States, the first thing that would come to mind in my head is like Solyndra, right? The Obama administration loves to sort of throw money at these, you know, clean energy projects that his friends run, and it's a disaster. They're buying these things from these companies because these companies can't compete in the marketplace. They're specifically buying something because it's a failure as a market product, and it hence does not make sense inherently.
Vincent, anything else you want to share, objections you want to bring up about this?
No, I just, I don't know if you want to keep me on a little longer to talk to Chris Cantwell about last night.
If you've got a quick question.
So I just was gonna ask, do you have any sort of training that the police in that area, because they seem remarkably sort of amenable to your presence in their midst, if they have any sort of de-escalation training that they offer in your area?
I
know in Seattle they do.
I can't speak to exactly what training the police have received here. They certainly know who we are, though, right? Now, you could say that with some of my rhetoric, police might see me as a threat to their safety and respond as such. But they also are aware to some extent that we are not in the habit of initiating force against people. If I have my gun pulled out on somebody, they have a pretty reasonable expectation that I'm defending myself, right? I'm not out victimizing people. They know that.
Let's talk about what happened. And this was not last night, by the way. Thanks, Vincent, for the call. It was a few nights ago.
Yeah.
Let's talk about what happened when the police showed up. So you had four psychopaths basically rushing at you for the most part, threatening you, perhaps threatening your life, because you were video recording in a public place when these women were being presumably threatened or harmed in some way by these men. But we'll come back with it. 855-450-FREE. It's Free Talk Live.
Measles is activating on a mass scale now due to the vaccines and iron poisoning. All symptoms, disease, and deaths are due to measles and iron, not just rash and flu-like symptoms, as the officials claim. Measles requires a host with iron to replicate. Iron intake is at an unprecedented level. Deaths and hospitalizations are set to soar now in 2015. This is the extermination plan, people. For further information, go to unveilingthem.com. UnveilingThem.com. Unveilingthem.com.
KatieArmor.com is your one-stop shop for the most affordable body armor period. With packages starting at $169.99 and free shipping on every order, Katie offers soft armor and rifle threat rated armor up to level 4. Go to KatieArmor.com and get your body armor today while you still can. Mention this ad and receive a free tactical scarf for a limited time with any body armor package. That's CatiArmor.com. Come and take it.
Cato University is the Cato Institute's premier educational event of the year. It's being held this year from July the 26th to the 31st at the Cato Institute's state-of-the-art headquarters in Washington, D.C. This annual program brings together outstanding faculty and participants from across the country and often from around the globe, with everyone sharing a commitment to liberty and learning. Cato University is a genuine community, and you can freely share viewpoints, concerns, ideas, questions, and more in an atmosphere of friendship and personal respect. It's a one-of-a-kind program for people who don't stop thinking after they got out of school. It's for people who don't want politicians or bureaucrats or officials to do their thinking for them. It's for people who value liberty. You'll learn, you'll be inspired, you'll make new friends, you'll meet great people from around the world. All of the details are spelled out at the Cato website, cato.org, and they hope to see you there this summer, July the 26th through the 31st in Washington, D.C. Again, details are at cato.org.
LRN.FM needs your help getting our satellite signal back on in Africa. Our satellite provider had us on at no charge from 2012 through February of this year when they pulled the channel off the air. Now we're trying to raise $22,000 to continue reaching people with the message of liberty in places where it's needed most. Please visit our Indiegogo fundraiser at africa.lrn.fm. Give what you can and share the link with your friends. africa.lrn.fm.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more.
It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
There are two types of advertising. Pull advertising, like Google AdWords, where a consumer goes looking for widgets near them and you try to pull them in with your ad away from the other widget purveyors. Then there's push advertising, where you push your message out about your great widgets and attempt to convince people who weren't thinking about widgets at all that what they need in their life right now is your widget. Radio is push advertising. In the course of a week, there are probably over 250,000 good folks listening to Free Talk Live, and they could hear your message. We're having a sale right now, and it ends May 15th. 200 30-second ads for $1,997. That's like 10 bucks an ad. Find another show with that kind of rate with 150-plus stations. Email me, Mark Edge, at mark@freetalklive.com, and I'll set you up. You don't need to have an ad. We'll produce it for you. Buy 200 30-second ads by May 15th and get them for less than $10 a piece. It's a big savings, and you don't want to miss it. Email me, mark@freetalklive.com, now.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
We're back with more Free Talk Live. Plenty of time for you to join us here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've been talking about, well, we mentioned solar roadways when a caller called in about that. For the most part, though, we're talking about Christopher Cantwell, who's in the studio with us here tonight, as normal on Wednesday nights. Just a few nights ago, he was in downtown Keene, New Hampshire, about 3 in the morning, when he heard some women, it sounded like, in distress. There were two men, two women. The women were crying. And Chris, you recorded video of that incident. Then all four of the people turned against you and demanded that you stop recording. You, feeling as though you were now under threat, felt it would be a bad idea to stop recording at that point.
Yep.
And you continued to record. They came at you and you pulled your gun. You've got a revolver that you carry openly, typically.
typically openly. That particular evening, I had a light jacket on, so it was hidden from plain sight, but I'm a concealed carry license holder in the state of New Hampshire.
You pulled that out. There's video of this, and you can see that video over at ChristopherCantwell.com. If you are on our Facebook and Twitter, I just hooted out or tweeted, Facebooked out the link, so it's right there on the Free Talk Live Facebook and Twitter, so go and grab it or check it out. There have been a lot of critiques. I think we should talk about some of those as well, including somebody claiming that it's aggression to take someone's picture in public. I really want to hear that critique.
Crazy people.
Supposed libertarians saying this. And so we can get into that. I also want to talk about the police and how they handled very well this particular situation.
Definitely.
But let's continue with your calls and thoughts. First, let's go to Jonathan, who's on the line via Skype. Jonathan, you're on Free Talk Live.
Yeah, guys. This story's a few weeks old, but here in Wisconsin, there was a bill from dealing with unions, collective bargaining, and public employee benefits and things like that. That was called Act 10. And the architects of that bill and some of the proponents of it have been targeted with SWAT raids in their home. And I got my information from Reason Magazine. And the thing that was striking to me about it was I found myself vacillating between sympathy and annoyance with the victims of the raids, because their attitude was, hey, wait a minute, you can't do that to us. You're supposed to be doing that to people who do drugs and stuff. We're law-abiding citizens.
So who was getting the raids? I'm sorry, I missed that. I was distracted with something.
The proponents of a bill here called the Wisconsin Budget Repair Bill.
Did they actually get raided, or were they threatened
yes.
to be raided?
They got raided, yes. Everything was taken, their laptops, their smartphones.
On what premise?
You caught me here.
And the bill was called what again?
Act 10. And it was also called the Wisconsin Budget Repair Bill.
Okay. So where did you hear about this?
Reason Magazine.
Got it.
Yeah, I mean, it's... if they're saying that they're being raided for what, being proponents of a law? Like,
yeah.
I can understand if, like, the police are being sent to their houses, like people are saying, hey, there's a violent, dangerous person in this house. Go send the SWAT team there as a way to harass them. But you're talking about a situation where police are actually seizing property from these people.
That sounds like cop organizations are getting budget cuts is what it sounds like.
Yeah.
Yes. And the district attorney, whose name is John Chisenholm, he's the district attorney from Milwaukee County. His wife is a union steward in a teacher's union, and he was kind of making this, as I heard it, a personal issue too. And I don't know what the premise was or what the reason was that they gave the official quote-unquote reason for raiding these people, but it's been going on too for about 2 years with other things, with the Scott Walker re-election or whatever it was, recall election.
Mm-hmm.
And it's been kind of crazy.
That's
crazy
a politician in Massachusetts.
I'm sorry, you're thinking of Scott Brown.
I don't know who all
Walker
these people
is
are.
The governor of Wisconsin.
Yeah. I'm not surprised to find public employee unions lashing out violently at people who oppose them. I've seen this firsthand. I mean, when I was getting started with the Tea Party in Long Island, you know, we'd see like SEIU and that sort of thing come out in favor of Obamacare, and there were times where it almost came to blows with those people. Now you go ahead and you militarize them in the form of a police force and give them the legal authority to break down doors with guns pointed at people, and I'm not surprised that could turn out extraordinarily bad.
Yeah. And it seems like, I'm no Republican by any means, but it seems like the union / left have been targeting Republicans, Tea Party, or things like that with the whole IRS thing and the police raids here in Wisconsin and things like that.
Sure looks like it.
Well, thanks for bringing that to the table, Jonathan. I've pulled up a little more information about it. Appreciate hearing from you. The toll-free number here tonight is 855-450-FREE. I've got the Reason piece about it here that he was talking about. It's, I guess they're summarizing a National Review piece, which is a deeper look into the lawfare assault on conservative supporters of union regulation reform in Wisconsin. It is chilling in the sense that it's genuinely disturbing to read about massive SWAT-style raids called in on families as part of politically motivated effort to find some sort of crime to pin on conservative supporters. It's also about how these political attacks have been chilling the speech and the activism of union reformers and conservatives in Wisconsin. David French opens his lengthy look at what went down in Wisconsin surrounding Act 10. That was the law that eliminated a significant amount of public sector union collective bargaining power, with eerily similar descriptions of three police raids targeting families, complete with warnings not to speak publicly about what authorities had taken from them or to consult a lawyer.
What?
You know, when they tell you you're not supposed to talk about it, that's when it always makes me even more nervous.
Yeah, I mean, I've heard about this in terms of, you know, these national security letters and that sort of thing, but a state or local police department issuing gag orders after they raid the homes of political activists, that is an extraordinarily dangerous scenario.
So I've got the full story, actually, from the National Review. It might be worth a look, a closer look. But let's go first to Bob in Michigan. Bob, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian, Chris Cantwell, and Mark.
Yeah, I heard you guys mention something about some entrepreneurial group or organization, something like Fort Galt.
Fort Galt. G-A-L-T.
Yeah.
Spell that again, please.
G as in Gary, A as in Alan, L as in Lisa, T as in Tom. Galt, like John Galt from the Atlas Shrugged books, I believe.
So you're saying it's Fort Galt?
That's correct.
Oh, no wonder.
Mark, maybe you should start spelling it when we do the live read.
Yeah, sounds like it. I sounded like Fort Galt.
So there you go, Bob. Did you have anything else you wanted to share tonight?
No. Okay. I just was...
Thanks for the call tonight. Appreciate it. Toll-free number.
Fair question.
855-450-FREE. Here's the story from the National Review. Cindy Archer, one of the lead architects of Wisconsin's Act 10, which is the law that limits public benefits or public employee benefits and altered collective bargaining rules for public unions, was jolted awake by yelling, loud pounding at the door, and her dog's frantic barking. The entire house, the windows and the walls, were shaking. She looked outside to see up to a dozen police officers yelling to open the door. They were carrying a battering ram. She wasn't dressed, but she started to run toward the door, her body in full view of the police. Some yelled at her to grab some clothes. Others yelled for her to open the door. She says, "I was so afraid, I didn't know what to do." She grabbed some clothes, opened the door, and dressed right in front of the police. The dogs were still frantic. "Please, don't shoot my dogs." I begged and begged, "Please don't shoot my dogs." I couldn't get them to stop barking, and I couldn't get them outside quick enough. I saw a gun and barking dogs. I was scared, and I knew this was a bad mix.
It is.
More of the story here in moments. Plus, we'll talk about how the police were a lot better here in Keene, New Hampshire, when they were dealing with Chris Cantwell, who pulled a gun on some psychos in downtown Keene a few nights ago. We'll come back to that story here in a moment because I think it's pretty important. 855-450-FREE is our toll-free number. You can share your thoughts on police raids or whatever's on your mind. It's Free Talk Live.
Warning. If you've recently declared bankruptcy, you're going to want to change the station because there's an alternative to bankruptcy and it's faster than you'd ever think possible. But if you've already declared bankruptcy and have missed this opportunity, you'll want to change the station now. Here it is. Right now, the company that has resolved more credit card debt than anyone in the U.S. is available to settle your debt, too. You may reduce your debt with one low monthly program payment. If you call right now, Freedom Debt Relief will show you how low your monthly program payment could be for free. Call now. 1-800-399-1993. That's 1-800-399-1993. If you're struggling with debt, this could be your answer. And the bigger your debt, the more money you could save. To find out for free how much of your hard-earned money Freedom Debt Relief could help you save, call now. 1-800-399-1993. 1-800-399-1993. 1-800-399-1993.
So Mark and I are out at the range shooting our AR-15 rifles built from AR-15 kits from Guns80.com when Dave walks up and he says, "Hey, did you guys hear about Jade Helm? You know, the government doesn't care about the Posse Comitatus Act, and Jade Helm, the troops are going to come and they may come after us and blah, blah, blah." And I'm thinking, oh my God, dude, look, I take a 30-shot magazine, I put it in my AR-15 built from a kit from Guns80.com, I unload it on the target. Jade Helm? I mean, really? Guns80.com, Guns80.com, Guns80.com. Go now.
KDArmor.com is your one-stop shop for the most affordable body armor, period. With packages starting at $169.99 and free shipping on every order. KD offers soft armor and rifle threat rated armor up to level 4. Go to KDArmor.com and get your body armor today while you still can. Mention this ad and receive a free tactical scarf for a limited time with any body armor package. That's CATIArmor.com. Come and take it.
The zebra of the plains is perpetually hunted by a myriad of merciless predators. With no purpose other than to feed monsters, the zebra spends its entire life standing around awaiting a violent death. They are nature's ultimate prey. The zebra paces the earth, patiently going through the motions of life, knowing that at any moment it will end in a sudden shock of pain and brutality. With its black and white stripes serving as an ostentatious beacon to any nearby predators, the zebra whiles away its time before gruesome elimination. Zebra, wait on the pantry shelf that is the African plain before something finds it and, at last, remembers to eat it.
Is the Onion News Network.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are: one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love, but make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate.
Oof, I think we've all had enough of that jingle, don't you? If you're going to invest in property in New Hampshire, it just makes sense to support a liberty-friendly realtor. Call Mark Warden of Team Porcupine Real Estate for investment property or rentals in the free state, or visit his website. Come on, you know it.
PorcupineRealEstate.com.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You may join us on the air here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. With you in studio, you've got Ian here.
Cantwell.
And Mark.
And don't forget to join us online, freetalklive.com. If you like the show and you want to help support Free Talk Live, get your shopping done with us. Go to shop.freetalklive.com. Enter Amazon through the links there. Amazon UK, Amazon Canada, Amazon US. You just go to the right Amazon for you, and Free Talk Live gets a cut of the sale. It's the same great Amazon you're used to with the same awesome prices. Just start your shopping at shop.freetalklive.com so Free Talk Live gets a cut of the sale. Also, when you're online, you need to protect yourself. And we can get you an awesome deal on some VPN, virtual private network service. This is a global virtual private network, ProXPN. They've got locations all around the world. And when you've got their premium account, you can select which server you want to connect to, which helps you get around those regionally blocked websites. You ever been to one of those sites that says, "We're sorry, we can't display this content because you're in the United States"? Well, you can just go to ProXPN and change your location and then go back to that website. And, you know, if you're using their Singapore server or their Netherlands server or wherever, there's other ones around the globe, then that website will then believe you are in those other locations and it'll show you that content. So that's one of the perks of ProXPN. They also give you, when you get their premium account, unlimited bandwidths, those servers around the world, private torrenting ability, and regionally, you can get around those regionally blocked websites. You go to proxpn.com/FTL to get started, and you can start for free, but you're going to want to upgrade to get those premium features. Use code FTL50 to get 50% off the price of the annual account. Now, whether you are on Windows, Mac, iOS, Android, Linux, they've got ProXPN for you, and you can protect yourself from your internet service provider, saving your surfing history. They're probably logging all the websites you visit.
They certainly are.
Keeping those logs, in some cases, for several years. You've got criminals trying to sniff out your Wi-Fi packets sometimes when you're out and about. You can stop all that from happening with ProXPN. Go to proxpn.com/FTL. You get it all with a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee. And our discount code, FTL50, locks in your 50% off savings on the annual plan for the lifetime of your account. So when you're ready to renew after year number one, to go to year number two, you get the same great deal. ProXPN.com/FTL, code FTL50. It's a great discount on privacy that is priceless. As we continue here, we're going to come back to Chris Cantwell's story, but we had a caller from Wisconsin earlier bring up a shocking story about political opponents being targeted by raids. Now, this isn't the first story of its type that we've ever heard. I remember this sort of rings back to a story about Joe Arpaio, which you may recall. And I don't know, it's been several years now since we talked about this, but Joe Arpaio, the so-called toughest sheriff in America, he actually sent his sheriff's department to raid the offices, I believe, of the city, if I'm recalling correctly. There was some government bureaucracy in Phoenix that had the sheriffs from Joe Arpaio show up. And wait, is Joe Arpaio the city
he's
cops?
The, he's no, sheriff, he, right? He is the county.
Right.
So, sheriffs or county?
Yeah, he came in there with his gang and basically held the other government bureaucrats at gunpoint and raided their offices, searching for paperwork. I forget what the reason was. It was
pretty thuggish behavior.
It was some trumped up nonsense that, you know, somebody in the office he didn't like and was trying to punish them. And so that sort of sounds like what's happening here in Wisconsin, where some of the advocates for this public benefits changes. There's this Act 10, the Wisconsin Budget Repair Bill, which would change the collective bargaining rules for public employee unions. The supporters of this have now been raided by police. One lady says she begged the police to not shoot her dogs when over a dozen officers, SWAT team, showed up in her home.
It's a smart thing to beg the police to not do.
Yeah, it's a reasonable assumption that they might do that, especially if one were a Free Talk Live listener.
She did get the dogs out safely before the police came inside, and some even barged into the bathroom where her partner was in the shower. The officer or agent in charge demanded Cindy sit on the couch, but she wanted to get up and get a cup of coffee. I told him this was my house and I could do what I wanted. Wrong thing to say. This made the agent in charge furious. He towered over me with his finger in my face and yelled like a drill sergeant that I either do it his way or he would handcuff me. They wouldn't let her speak to a lawyer. She looked outside and saw a person who appeared to be a reporter. Someone had tipped him off. The neighbors started to come outside, curious at the commotion, and all the while police searched her home, making a mess. And according to Cindy, leaving her dead mother's belongings strewn across the basement floor in a most disrespectful way. Hmm. They then left, carrying with them only a cell phone and a laptop. That was the first. Now, another paragraph. This is another victim. It's a matter of life or death. That was the first thought of Anne, which is not her real name. Someone was pounding at her front door. It was very early in the morning. And it was the kind of heavy pounding that meant someone was either fleeing from or bringing trouble. She said it was so hard, I'd never heard anything like it. I thought someone was dying outside.
It's really difficult to ignore that kind of pounding, and I think that that's one of the reasons the police pound that way, right? Mm-hmm. It's the sort of thing that really raises your hackles. If somebody's beating on your door like that, I don't have too many people knock on my door generally, and when they do, they sort of, you know, knock in a normal knocking fashion. You hear that bang, 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 bang. You know, immediately you're like, what are you going to do? Because that way you come to the door. There's not much they can do if you don't come to the door.
No, there's something they can do, all right. They can knock that door off its hinges. That's right. I think that what they're saying, that they came with a battering ram.
In the first story, they had a ram. Not sure about this one. They probably did. She ran to the door, opened it, and then chaos. Quote, people came pouring in. For a second, I thought it was a home invasion. It was terrifying. They were yelling and running into every room in the house. One of the men was in my face, yelling at me over and over and over. Unquote.
I just want to pause you for a second there. She says it was almost like a home invasion. No, it was a home invasion. They just happened to have badges.
Yeah, which means they won't get charged with a home invasion because they're immune. It was indeed a home invasion, but the people who were pouring in were Wisconsin law enforcement officers. Armed, uniformed police swarmed into the house. Plainclothes investigators cornered her and her newly awakened family. Soon, state officials were seizing the family's personal property, including each person's computer and smartphone.
They did this in plain clothes?
Yeah. Yep. No. Uniformed. Uniformed and plain clothes, so both.
Okay.
Each filled with the most intimate family information. Why were the police at her home? She had no answers. The police were treating them the way they'd seen police treat drug dealers on television. In fact, TV or movies were their only points of reference because they weren't criminals. They were law-abiding. They didn't buy or sell drugs. They weren't violent. They weren't a danger to anyone. Yet there were cops surrounding their house on the outside, swarming the house on the inside. They even taunted the family as if they were mere perps. As if the home invasion, the appropriation of private property, and the verbal abuse weren't enough, next came ominous warnings. Don't call your lawyer. Don't tell anyone about this raid, not even your mother, your father, or your closest friends. The neighborhood, the entire neighborhood, could see the police around their house, but they had to remain silent. This was not the right to remain silent, as uttered by every cop on every legal drama on television, the right against self-incrimination. No, they couldn't mount a public defense if they wanted, or even offer an explanation to family and friends. Yet no one in this family was a perp. Instead, like Cindy, they were American citizens guilty of nothing more than exercising their First Amendment rights to support Act 10 and other conservative causes in Wisconsin. Sitting there shocked and terrified, this citizen, who is still too intimidated to speak on the record, kept thinking, is this America? Now look, if the cops come into your home and tell you don't call your lawyer, don't tell anyone about the raid, I would recommend you do the opposite.
Yeah, no, that isn't them acting like this is America, I can assure you.
Yeah, this is a whole new level of scary that I am surprised to be hearing about. And with some of the things that we talk about on this show, I'm not usually surprised, right? Mm-hmm. We talk about a government completely run amok doing very dangerous, evil, violent things all of the time, every single day. And it's just like, okay, on to the next one. This scares the life out of me because I don't know that I've heard of something like this before. You get SWAT raids saying, keep it a secret? And they don't even, I mean, I'm waiting to hear the description of the crime they've been charged with. Normally, if they're going to raid your home, even if it's politically motivated, they'll at least trump up some charge. I'm not hearing about people being arrested for crimes here.
Right, and I haven't read this. Right, we haven't done any prep on this, right? We just had the guy call the show. He mentioned this was happening. I went, looked for it, found the story. So we're all learning about this at the same time. Maybe they'll tell us something about some charges. But it sounds like they're just confiscating stuff. So it sounds to me like they have a warrant. It's a search warrant, and the search warrant is for electronic devices, which may have some evidence of, I'm going to guess, some sort of conspiracy charge, perhaps. But that's just me speculating here. We're going to continue with the stories. There's a third one here, the family of Rachel, which is also not her real name. For their family, their ordeal began before dawn, with the same loud, insistent knocking. Still in her pajamas, Rachel
before
answered
dawn.
The door.
Can you imagine?
And saw uniformed police poised to enter her home. When Rachel asked to wake her children herself, the officer insisted on walking into their rooms. The kids woke to an armed officer standing near their beds. The entire family was herded into one room, and there they watched as police carried off their personal possessions, including items that had nothing to do with the subject of the search warrant, even her daughter's computer. And yes, there were the warnings. Don't call your lawyer. Don't talk to anyone about this. Don't tell your friends. We'll tell you more about this here in moments. 855-450-FREE. This is happening in Wisconsin. There's more on the way. Hour 2's coming up on Free Talk Live.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom. And with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, or read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
Are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency, and Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, you're helping the state. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available right now. Learn it, use it, and spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Wednesday, May 13th, 2015. Silver is trading at $16.95 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,203 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $245. Antiwar.com reports 6 weeks into their aerial campaign and after 48 hours of severe escalation, Saudi Arabia has announced a temporary halt to their airstrikes against Yemen, the beginning of what they say will be a five-day humanitarian pause. There is skepticism, but also a lot of hope among Yemeni civilians who are hoping their cities won't be bombed over the next few days, and hoping even more that the Saudi naval blockade will begin allowing humanitarian aid into the country. While fighting picked up, particularly along the border in the hours leading up to the 11 p.m. deadline, residents of Yemeni cities have reported no incidents in the first couple of hours since. Saudi military commanders say that despite the pause, they will continue overflights of Yemen for surveillance purposes and will resume strikes if they believe the Houthis are violating the terms of the deal, which includes that none of their troops move for the next 5 days. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. UPI reports a 7.3 magnitude earthquake struck Nepal on Tuesday, just weeks after another earthquake devastated parts of the nation and killed more than 8,000 people. At least 37 people were killed and more than 1,000 injured in the town of Chatara by the latest earthquake. At least 17 also died in India and one in Tibet. A 6.3 magnitude aftershock followed shortly after Tuesday's quake. The earthquake occurred about 50 miles east of Kathmandu, the country's capital. The latest quake struck at a depth of 9 miles, and Nepal is still recovering from the magnitude 7.8 earthquake that struck the central part of the country on April 25th, leading to thousands of deaths and 17,000 injured. The effects of the latest quake were felt in Kathmandu, but there were no reports of significant damage there. The Save the Children charity said teams were assessing the impact on buildings that had already been damaged and told USA Today, "It's a terrifying time for the hundreds of thousands of children and families who lost everything in the April 25th earthquake." Meanwhile, a U.S. Marines helicopter conducted disaster relief missions in Nepal went missing on Tuesday. ExpressCoin is the best choice for buying Bitcoin, Litecoin, Dogecoin, and more. ExpressCoin prides themselves on their customer service, so much so that the back end on the website should allow them to be even more focused on your needs. Get your cryptocurrencies with money order, check, wire transfer, or cash deposit. Get started at expresscoin.fppradio.com. That's expresscoin.fppradio.com.
Reuters reports Texas on Tuesday executed a man convicted of murdering his girlfriend, her mother, and grandfather in their Houston home in 2002 as he took revenge on the family for trying to cut off his relationship with the daughter. Derek Charles was announced dead at 6:36 p.m. Central Time after receiving a lethal injection at the state's death chamber in Huntsville, according to prison officials. Charles, who strangled all three, was the 525th inmate executed in Texas since the U.S. Supreme Court reinstated the death penalty in 1976, with the state accounting for 37% of all executions in the country during the time. The U.S. Supreme Court denied a petition seeking to halt the execution. Lawyers for Charles had argued that he was mentally incompetent and could not legally be subject to capital punishment. At the time of the crime, Charles was 19 and out on parole for burglary. Prosecutors said he sought revenge on Brenda Bennett because she was trying to stop her underage daughter, Maisha, from having sex with Charles. Charles hid in the family home and first beat Obie Bennett with a lamp and trophies. The grandfather was found in the kitchen with an electrical cord around his neck, according to prosecutors and the Texas Attorney General. He then waited for Brenda and Maisha to come home. When they arrived, he bound and gagged them. According to prosecutors, he killed Maisha and sexually assaulted and strangled her mother. He pled guilty to the crime and was later sentenced to death. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
It's the Onion Radio News. JCPenney abandons its 45-second sale. This is Doyle Redland reporting. Word came today from JCPenney headquarters in Plano, Texas, that the retail giant will discontinue its 45-second sale. The bargain bonanza, in which all JCPenney merchandise is discounted by 60% for 45 seconds starting at 1 p.m. daily, simply wasn't pulling in enough revenue. CEO Alan Questrom.
The 45-second sale drew very strong customer response, but regrettably, only a handful of shoppers actually got to capitalize on our fantastic prices due to the horrific injuries they sustained during their stampede to the cashier.
Questrom added that plans are in the works to create a longer two-minute sale intended to give frantic shoppers at least a fighting chance to enjoy incredible store-wide savings. Doyle Redland for the Onion Radio News, online at theonion.com.
This is the Onion News Network.
We are back with more Free Talk Live, launching into the second hour of the program. Plenty of time for you with your calls and thoughts at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We're going to get more into what happened with Chris Cantwell, who's in our studio here tonight, Ian, Mark, and Cantwell, a few nights ago here in Keene, New Hampshire, where you had to draw your gun on some advancing maniacs who appeared very intent on causing you harm because you were recording an in-the-streets conflict that was happening at like 3 in the morning in downtown Keene, New Hampshire. The police came, and you ended up with no holes in your chest.
Surprisingly enough.
As a result. So we'll talk about that here. But we actually are in the middle, for those of you just tuning in, we're in the middle of a story, which I'm not going to read the whole thing because it's really long, from the National Review. And it gets political later, which I don't really care about. Talking about like the political personalities in Wisconsin, which don't interest me at all. But what does interest me is that there apparently are being police raids are being performed against political opponents in Wisconsin. So there's this what's called Act 10, and the way this is described is with the Wisconsin Budget Repair Bill. This limits public employee benefits and altered collective bargaining rules for public employee unions. I don't know if that thing's passed or what the status of this Act 10 is, but
it's frightening.
It sounds like the government bureaucrats are doing whatever they can to strike the fear of the state into those people who are trying to restrict the, you know, the bennies of the those very state agents. So no one should really be surprised that they're acting in a violent manner here. But Chris Cantwell, you say you are surprised about this. You've never heard anything like this before.
Of police raiding a house, seizing property, and then telling people to not call their lawyers or talk about the incident. That sounds to me like a new level of scary. Correct me if I'm wrong.
It's pretty scary. I mean, we know that the government, the federal level, has been issuing these national security letters for years, where if you get one of these NSLs, you are ordered to not talk about, you know, that you've received it. So that's not unheard of previously. That doesn't mean it's okay. It's a terrible, scary thing. It's an obvious infringement on free speech. But that's happened. Now it's combined and with a police raid.
Yeah, and that's done under the auspices of we're doing this to prevent, you know, terrorism and foreign threats. Well, this is being done, as it sounds to be so far in the article, as we've gotten through it, this is a politically motivated thing where people are having their homes broken into and ransacked and then being told, don't contact your lawyer by a state and or local police department.
Right. And so we're in the third of three stories, what I believe will be three stories here. We've got Rachel, which is not her real name. Her family was herded into one room and watched as the police carried off their personal possessions, including items that had nothing to do with the subject of the search warrant. And they were given the similar warnings of don't call your lawyer, don't talk to anyone, don't tell your friends. The kids watched, alarmed, as the school bus drove by, with students inside watching the spectacle of uniformed police surrounding the house, carrying out their belongings.
Yeah, imagine what that's like. I mean, these are your friends know where you live because you get picked up near your house, and there they go by on the school bus, and there's all kinds of police cars loaded out in front of your house. Good luck explaining that tomorrow at school, because you probably miss today's school because the cops have you huddled in a room.
Well, right.
I should, you know what? I'm tired of calling these people cops. I mean, let's just start calling them what they are. These people are brown shirts. This is the Stasi. I mean, any kind of pejorative meted out against one of these union thugs that happens to have a badge and a gun is just too good for them.
They were also told they couldn't tell anyone at school, so they had to remain silent, ostensibly. Again, what is the consequence going to be? They've already raided your home. Are they going to execute you if you go ahead and
speak
about this?
They're going to put you in jail if they feel like it.
Yeah, if you think this house raid was bad, you just go ahead, mention it to somebody and see what happens to you then.
The mom watched as her entire life was laid open before police, her professional files, personal files, everything. She knew this was all politics. She knew a rogue prosecutor was targeting her for her political beliefs, and she realized that every aspect of her life, she said, was in their hands, and they hate me, unquote. Fortunately for her family, the police didn't taunt her or her children. Some of them seemed embarrassed by what they were doing, and at the end of the ordeal, one officer looked at the family still confined to one room and said, "Some days I hate my job." For dozens of conservatives, the years since Scott Walker's first election as the governor of Wisconsin transformed the state into a place where conservatives have faced early morning raids, multi-year secretive criminal investigations, slanderous and secretive leaks to sympathetic media, and intrusive electronic snooping. Yes, Wisconsin, the cradle of the progressive movement and home of the Wisconsin idea, the marriage of state governments and state universities to govern through technocratic reform, was giving birth to a new progressive idea, the use of law enforcement as a political instrument, as a weapon to attempt to undo election results, shame opponents, and ruin lives. Most Americans have never heard of these raids or of the lengthy criminal investigations of Wisconsin conservatives, and for good reason. Bound by comprehensive secrecy orders, conservatives were left to suffer in silence as leaks ruined their reputations, as neighbors looking through windows and dismayed at the massive police presence, the lights shining down on targets' homes, wondered, no doubt, what on earth did that family do? Well, look, I don't want to put blame on these people. They, you know, they don't deserve this. I'm not saying they deserve this. But every single one of these conservatives who's bemoaning what's happening here, oh, how could this happen to us? This is America. We're not drug dealers. Well, you guys cheered it on when it was happening to the drug dealers, didn't you? You thought this was A-OK, totally fine, hunky-dory, when the cops were busting down pot dealers' doors, when they were, you know, throwing people in prison and destroying families over a little LSD or some MDMA or whatever. And you guys stood in the wings and you talked about how great the police were. And thank you, police, for keeping our streets clean and safe. And oh, what do you know? Now the very same auspices, the same tools of violence have been turned against you.
Yeah,
surprise.
It's. I hope that people who are concerned about this are looking at it as sort of a wake-up call that this is what happens when you give people this kind of power over you. When you create a system where people have the power to break down doors violently in the middle of the night and seize property from people, hey, maybe that's not the best of ideas. Maybe it's not a good idea to have a massive militarized force roaming the streets of your city taking property from people who have harmed nobody. Might be a little thing that you want to get concerned about before it happens to you.
So don't be surprised when you've helped build and cheer on the sort of the tools of tyranny here, and then when they turn those tools against you, when you lose political power and somebody else gets into office, and then they decide that you're the enemy and that you need to be stopped and intimidated.
Right. You don't get freedom by advocating for tyranny for other people. As a matter of fact, To get freedom, first you must be able to define it. And the vast majority of conservatives and liberals and progressives and whatever else they are out there can't even define it. They don't even know what it means.
Share your thoughts with us here at 855-450-FREE. I'm not going to go on with the rest of this article. It's very, very lengthy, but we will post it up on our Facebook and Google Plus, and you can not Google Plus. We're not really doing that anymore. Twitter. And you can check it out when you get a chance. You can go to news.freetalklive.com to access those. Let's talk to Zach, listening in Chicago. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Zach.
Hey. Oh, hold on one second. Let me take out speaker.
Oh, well, that would be appreciated. Normally, you will sound better if you are not on speakerphone.
Yeah. That good?
Go ahead, Zach.
All right. So, first, I just wanted to say, like, thank you for kind of discussing that Coast Guard thing. Either was that yesterday or 2 days ago?
And, yeah, a gentleman called in, and he was going to go. He needed some money to go to college, so he decided he was going to go into. What's that?
That was actually me.
Okay, great.
Yeah, I was just saying thank you.
Sure.
No,
well,
you're welcome.
Do a little recap for everybody here, so that folks that are listening will know what happened, and then tell us what you liked about it.
Basically, I called in about something else, and then just kind of requested your opinion on the Coast Guard, and. You guys and the fact that I was joining, and one of my big motivators was, you know, some money for college. And you kind of rebutted that and offered, kind of said that I should look more in depth and see if there's other avenues I can pursue to kind of obtain some money for college. And, even after I got off the phone, I think you spent a decent amount of the next segment kind of talking about that. And a guy from, I think, the Army or Navy called in and kind of discussed his experience with it. And I was just really appreciative of the fact that you kind of gave that some time and gave me a little bit of food for thought and an alternate viewpoint from everyone else kind of cheering me on saying, oh, yeah, Coast Guard.
Yeah, that's true.
I think it's a subject that's worth discussing. We did want to ask you.
Hold that thought, Mark. Whatever it is you want to ask, we'll bring Zach back here in a moment because actually he's calling for a different reason, I think. 855-450-FREE is our number. Free Talk Live.
When we ran out, we stopped using it.
Why would you stop?
Why undo all the good that's been accomplished? We thought everything was fine, and that was not a good thing.
No.
He started stinking. It was awful.
Shedding comes back, loss of hair, lots of dandruff.
Scratching will return. His shedding will increase.
If I ever took Roy off of Dynavite, he would go back to his hair loss.
DINOVITE.com.
859-428-1000.
When I get down to the bottom of my box of Dynavite.
When I get to about 3/4.
Oh no, I've got a couple more scoops.
It's time to place my order. Dynavite.com.
Each and every day she is getting a Dynavite.
The omega-3 fatty acids.
Flaxseed, zinc, alfalfa.
The digestive enzymes that are cooked out of regular dog food.
Just feed your dog right. Use Dynavite. If it's working, don't quit.
Don't do what I did and run out.
859-428-1000.
859-428-1000.
DINOVITE.com.
Again, the Congressional Budget Office sounds the alarm. This time warns of Greek-style U.S. debt crises. You heard me right. The GAO is drawing a parallel between the U.S. economy, its debt, and the current Greek economic meltdown. With the debt-to-GDP chart climbing into unfamiliar territory, the growing budget deficit will rise to unsupportable levels. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. The Federal Debt and Risk of Financial Crises document the CBO has published is a must-read for every American. Covering the risk of continued deficit spending coupled with an aging population and the rising interest rates spell economic disaster. It's imperative that you get a copy of this document and study it for yourself. Call me today at 800-686-2237, and I'll send you a free copy. Again, call 800-686-2237 and ask for your copy of the CBO document. Once again, you need to read this government report. Call 800-686-2237.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the Liberty Media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com. Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Welcome to Free Talk Live. We're here to take your calls about whatever's on your mind. Plus, coming up, more on Chris Cantwell's encounter with some psychopaths in downtown Keene, New Hampshire, where he had to pull his gun to try to, in hopes to not actually have to shoot this person, but it came damn close. In fact, had you not been carrying a revolver, you may have apparently shot these people. We can talk more about the details of what went down. It's gone viral, by the way, the article over at ChristopherCantwell.com, the video on YouTube. I checked a couple days ago. It had 50,000 views.
Oh, it's over 500,000 at this point.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow, that's pretty impressive.
We were getting pretty close to 600,000 last I checked, and I have not checked the stats today.
It's obviously already hit the gun rights community. I mean, that's why it's going crazy like that.
Yeah, and that's where some of the criticism comes from, and I'd like to get into that.
Me too. We'll come back to it here in a moment. Your calls come first, and also I want to let you know where to go to get Bitcoin. Go to expresscoin.com. You can get Bitcoin, Litecoin, Dogecoin as well. It's fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive. ExpressCoin is the best choice for getting your cryptocurrencies. You can use a money order or check. And they're a licensed money services business. You can start off over at ExpressCoin.com, whether you're in the U.S. or Canada. Just go to ExpressCoin.com, and you can do it from your smartphone via their app, which you can download at ExpressCoin.com. Don't forget to use coupon code FTL, and you'll get up to $40 worth of cryptocurrency with no fee at all, no transfer fee on up to $40 worth of Bitcoin or one of those other ones. If you use code FTL, for your coupon code at expresscoin.com. Again, that's expresscoin.com. Zach is back with us here in Chicago. Zach, you had called in. You were talking about thinking about moving or going into the, not the Marine Corps, it was the, oh God, what was
Coast Guard.
It? The Coast Guard. Thank you. You're going into the Coast Guard, and Mark really confronted you, I think, with a good question about, you know, would you be willing to shoot someone whose only desire was to be more free, who, you know, if they cross a certain threshold on a boat or something, they can get to more freedom, but your job would be to prevent that from happening, and your superiors will order you to shoot this person who hasn't hurt anyone else. They're just seeking more freedom, and that put you, I think, into a very difficult position because you seem to be someone who cares about freedom, but yet you would be in a role where you would be oppressing people's freedom. And so it gave you a few things to think about. And was there further that you wanted to add to that discussion? Because then Mark had a question for you.
No, I'm I'm good on that.
You're complete? Okay. So one of the things is that I think is unfair for, you know, preachers like Ian and I to get out there and say, you shouldn't do that without giving somebody some kind of, you know, alternatives. And because it's, you know, you shouldn't go into the military is a prohibition. It's not a path for, it's not a suggestion. It's really not giving anybody any kind of help. And we didn't ask you what you wanted to do as far as going to college and that sort of thing, because you wanted the money for college. So what do you want to go to college for?
I'm wanting to go to college and study political science.
You're passionate about that. What are you hoping to, what kind of career are you hoping to get into?
I either wanted to be a like major in political science and minor in journalism. And I really want to be like do some alternative news and kind of like what you guys do, but maybe more on the like the writing side and like internet articles, blog posts, stuff like that.
Yeah, I don't think you need to go to college to write on a blog. I mean, that's just my opinion.
What it is a lot of it's just like credibility, though. And I mean, I obviously if I don't have to go to college, I don't want to. So I looked into it a little bit. And a lot of it is just, like, people don't take you seriously unless you have a degree, and whether that's right or wrong.
I don't know who those people are.
Those type of people certainly do exist, especially if you're trying to write for somebody else. Credentials are certainly helpful. Mm-hmm. As a guy who does make his living as a blogger and a talker, I can tell you that I am a high school dropout, and there are certainly people in this world who do not take me seriously. But you know, when I put out content, that content either grabs the attention of readers or it does not, and it gets around. And you know, there's a number of ways that you can monetize that. That said, I'm not exactly getting rich doing it, so I might not be the best person to take advice from.
Yeah, I see that. Now, look, as far as what you were saying, political science, isn't political science like a degree that you get if you want to be a teacher? Like, what do you do with a political science
degree? If you want to be a politician, I think, or, you know, some kind of... some kind of think tank. Well, that's where you start. You get the political science degree, then you go work for the think tank, then you get you work for some campaigns while you're at the think tank, and then as you work for the campaigns, you move up as a campaigner, and then, you know, a political operative, perhaps, you know, at some point or another, you run your own campaign.
It doesn't sound worth 4 years of schooling to me.
Well, so what I would say to this is that, again, Ian, you're just saying...
But I'm a skeptic.
Nuh-uh, and nuh-uh isn't particularly helpful. My suggestion would be is... Why don't you check out some of these organizations that you respect? Like maybe you like Reason Magazine, or maybe you like, you know, I don't know, just some of these other organizations.
I might suggest you go to the Mises Institute before you go to Reason or Cato.
Fine. You know, any of these liberty organizations, if that's your bend.
Check them out to what? Ask about what does it require to get a job there or something?
Be an intern. I know that the IHS offers summer internship programs.
Institute for Humane Studies.
Yep, the Institute for Humane Studies. Also, FEE, the Foundation for Economic FEE. What is FEE?
Foundation for Economic Education.
Education.
Now, isn't it the case that you have to be in college to go to those?
I don't know what the specifics are.
I don't either.
Think you have to be just college age.
Yeah, you might be right.
Check out these internships where they actually, in some cases, they actually get you paid, and see whether you can get on with one of these organizations as an, you know, a low-paid intern. You're going to learn as much, if not more, in 4 years working for crap money from these people than even Cato in Washington. They've got all kinds of interns there all the time.
There's no better way to parlay into an actual paid position than to be an intern somewhere. At least that's been my experience.
And a lot of times they'll have scholarship programs built out into these organizations. They want to send you to George Mason University.
Yeah, let the Koch brothers pay the tab.
Darn right. and this way you're not put into some situation where you know, you have to compromise your principles, and you're probably going to be safer as a result.
Zach, what was the other reason you were calling tonight? Go real quick with that.
Okay, I wanted to actually ask Mark a few questions about unschooling and homeschooling.
I'll give you one question for tonight. Go ahead.
Okay. Have you had problems with trying to unschool your son, I believe, and like with the government, have you had them try to like come in and tell you what you can and can't do, or been tried to force to take certain tests or whatnot?
Excellent question.
Each state is different on this and what the requirements are. In New Hampshire, you're supposed to fill out, I think it's an annual report of what it is you're doing, lesson plan, that sort of thing. Mm. But we never had him in government school, so he's not as much on their radar. However,
so you're not doing that then?
Jack,
civil disobedience?
No, we are not doing that, but Jack is not a New Hampshire resident.
Jack, what does that mean? Is he an inhabitant?
No, he lives in Florida.
Oh.
So because my wife goes back and forth between the two states.
What's the requirement in Florida?
I have no idea. He's not there all the time.
I suspect you're breaking Florida law. Thank you for the call, Zach. Appreciate hearing from you. 855-450-FREE.
Then he'll be a Georgia resident after that.
855-450-3733. I say embrace the civil disobedience. You shouldn't have to tell some bureaucrat how you're educating your kids. 855-450-FREE. And I wish more homeschoolers and unschoolers would just opt out and say, screw you, bureaucrats. It's Free Talk Live.
Virtually anyone can hack your cell phone and track your calls, your texts, your emails, your every movement, but only if they can detect a signal. Stay one step ahead of hackers and Big Brother with a Blockit Pocket, a custom-made pocket infused with pure silver that creates a complete Faraday enclosure for your cell phone. For free shipping to the Lower 48, visit blockitpocket.com or call 888-315-9618. blockitpocket.com. Enhancing health and privacy.
KatieArmor.com is your one-stop shop for the most affordable body armor period. With packages starting at $169.99 and free shipping on every order, Katie offers soft armor and rifle threat rated armor up to level 4. Go to KatieArmor.com and get your body armor today while you still can. Mention this ad and receive a free tactical scarf for a limited time with any body armor package. That's CatiArmor.com. Come and take it.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
6 drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies! Jesus. On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, or read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
The 3 most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, 1, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. 2, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. 3, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Hey guys, Mark Claire here, lionsofliberty.com, where we strive to advance the ideas of liberty daily. We bring you The Morning Roar! That's right, every Monday to Friday, we'll have a brand new edition of The Morning Roar, where we provide a roundup of some news stories that you may not find in the mainstream media, or even in your typical social media news feed. We find stories that relate to the ideas of liberty and provide you with our liberty perspective on them. Every Monday, we have our longest-running feature, Mondays with Murray, named after the great libertarian Murray Rothbard, where we'll examine an article or an excerpt from his works and help convey his view, along with our little spin as well. We wrap it all up every Friday with Felony Friday, where our own John Odermatt goes out and takes a look at some sort of felony. There's felonies committed every day, you know, whether it's a felony committed by the police, a politician, or even an average citizen. You can find all of this and so much more over at lionsofliberty.com. Advancing the ideas of liberty daily.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Join us here toll-free. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Joining us here tonight, or joining you here tonight, it's Ian
Cantwell
and Mark.
ChristopherCantwell.com is his website. Ours, freetalklive.com. Mark, coming up in July, you're going to be in Vegas for Freedom Fest.
That's right. From the 8th to the 11th, Freedom Fest is going on. It's the world's largest gathering of free minds. This year's theme is Discover the New American Dream. And it's going to be a lot of fun. It's a big event. I'd say the biggest event ever as far as they go, and maybe of all Liberty events. They're going to have Paul Krugman and debate Steve Moore. Now, Steve Moore is the Wall Street Journal columnist and chief economist for the Heritage Foundation. Paul Krugman is the Nobel Prize-winning economist and New York Times columnist, and they're going to debate austerity versus stimulus, red state versus blue state, flat tax versus progressive tax. I think this is going to be an incredible event. And for that, you know, if it was just that, this event would be worth going to. But there's going to be all kinds of big names at this event. Senator Mike Lee, Grover Norquist, Congressman Alan West, George Gilder, John Allison, Glenn Beck, John Fund, Star Parker, Justin Amash, Floyd Brown, Joseph Farrar, the Skousens who throw the event, Dinesh D'Souza, Peter Thiel, Steve Forbes, John Mackey. This is the biggest event, and it's got the biggest names. It's got a huge vendor area. It's going to be a lot of fun. Please come out and hang out with me at Freedom Fest. If you decide to go, make sure you click that you heard it on the radio. That will let them know that you heard it from Free Talk Live. They're kind of testing us out here, and I'd love to have them come on board as a much bigger sponsor of Free Talk Live. So it's freedomfest.com. You can actually call them too. Freedomfest.com. The number is 855-850-FREE. It's 855-850-FREE for Freedom Fest.
All right, let's go right back into your calls and thoughts. We've got Jimmy in Tucson. You're on Free Talk Live. Hey, Jimmy.
Hey, guys. Jimmy. Hey, I just want to say I'm proud of Cantwell and how he handled that situation.
Well, thank you,
and,
Jimmy.
Yeah, I wish he would have been there when my wife Milfred was beating my ass. And, But,
you think she would have been dissuaded by just a handgun?
I don't know. You know, she's been having a lot of problems here lately because she's a competitive bodybuilder, power lifter, and eater. And she's on a lot of steroids. So she was roid raging on me one day. You know, she got upset with me. She ended up beating me up, and I was upset. I wish somebody had been there and helped me out. And
I would definitely come to your come to your aid, Jimmy. You've been a source of much entertainment here on Free Talk Live, and I hate to see anything bad happen to
What's
you.
It like when a woman is roid raging? Normally, you hear about steroids with beefy beefcake men, weightlifters and cops and things like that.
Oh, it's demeaning, and it made me upset. And the reason she did it, I thought was ridiculous. You know, she was pretty upset over something that I thought was kind of silly.
What's that?
And she got upset with me because I accidentally gave her favorite chihuahua chlamydia. She got a little mad at me.
Oh my, you naughty boy, Jimmy. Thanks for the call. 855-450-FREE.
Milfred has quite a temper anyway, is what I hear. I can only imagine when she's on the steroids how that is.
I think that might be Jimmy's best call yet. Gave the chihuahua chlamydia.
Joe is in Houston, Texas. You're on Free Talk Live. Hey, Joe.
Yeah, hello?
Hey, you're on the air. Go ahead.
Yeah, guys, what's up? I'm a first-time caller, a long-time listener. I don't know if you guys talked about this, but it's about this attorney in California. He's trying to pass a petition to get it on the ballot so they can end alimony. And I want to say that I think it's a good idea because if you guys notice, too many women are getting away with basically literally murdering court. I don't understand why when you divorce a woman, we have to continue paying them. What do you guys think about that?
Well, so I'm a little bit torn about this. I oppose alimony flat out. Let me say something to that, right? But I do sort of feel like if you if a person is basically putting themselves in a situation where they're dependent on you, and you are leading them to believe that they will be able to be dependent on you forever, I have some sympathy for the desire to see them taken care of in some way afterwards. However, what's being done to men in family courts these days is absolutely horrendous, and alimony is one really terrible example of that. I mean, it's after we are in a marriage, the marriage is not working out, and so I'm going to leave you, and that's going to incur obligations on me to uphold your what's the line that they give you, the standard of living to which they have become accustomed.
Yeah, it's terrible.
That's sick and depraved, because the way that we were able to achieve that standard of living was by both of us having that standard of living, for me to go and move out of the house and be separate from you, and I'm going to have to work twice as hard to maintain my own standard of living.
Right,
that's
because
sick.
You're two people under the same roof. You're sharing bills, or at least to some extent, you have shared responsibilities. At the very least, maybe, you know, you're paying the bills, but she's taking care of the house or something like that, right? But now you're outside of that relationship. You're now on your own, presumably, until you can find somebody else, and then you still have to the burden of taking care of this lady, and that's like twice the burden.
Yeah, and I'm sympathetic to the idea behind it, because there's a statistic floats around that people say married men make 38% more than their single counterparts.
It's
right?
Probably so just their age.
It's probably has something to do with age. It has something to do with their drive to get more, right? Because if they've got a family at home, they're necessarily going to, you know, strive to achieve more. And it's also just, you know, she's assisting you in your productivity, right? So, I mean, there's a woman is certainly providing a great deal inside of a marital relationship. But if that relationship goes south, that doesn't mean that you get to collect a check every week for the rest of your life, or however long a period of time they command.
Yeah, but here's what angers me is that I'm not saying all women, but most women in America, they love to say how they're independent and this and that, but they sure want what's in our pocket. You know what I mean?
Well, because it's foundationally ridiculous to say that they are going to be as independent as they would like to make themselves out to be. It's just men and women have relationships for reasons, and that structure has been responsible for mankind becoming the undisputed ruling species of the planet. And there are people who want to dismantle that, and those people are going contrary to our nature, and we are having catastrophic outcomes as a result.
Well, I think that people should be able to live the life they want to live, right? Like, so if a woman decides, I don't want to marry a man, I want to make it on my own and be a... you know, something in a field where men generally dominate. I want to be a doctor, or whatever it is that person wants to do. They should be able to do that if that's what they want
to
do.
If they are able to do that. If
Completely,
they are going to a courthouse to get it done, then they are by definition incapable of doing that.
Agreed.
Joe, thanks for calling with that tonight. Appreciate it. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. And you can join us on Skype as well. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. So let's go back to the story that we were discussing previously, Chris Cantwell. You were in the streets of Keene, 3 a.m, a few nights ago, on the way home. You heard some commotion. Sounded like some women were crying and they were frustrated. Then you pulled out your camera, you started recording that situation, and then both the men who were sort of threatening these women and the women turned against you.
Yes.
And demanded you turn the camera off. You refused to do that because you're in a situation now with some people who are potentially threatening to you. And it's a wise idea to keep rolling in a situation like that.
Yeah, I saw a situation that I thought might become violent, and sure enough, it did become violent, so it would seem that my assessment of the situation was quite accurate.
Luckily, you just refocused the violence on yourself.
Yep,
well,
sure did.
Yeah, it wasn't his intention, but that's what happened. He pulled a gun, pulled a gun out on these people when they rushed you, and you held them at bay. You managed to, now the video, you drop the camera when the gun comes out.
Right, but the audio continues to roll.
You get the audio track. The police show up shortly thereafter, and I want to continue the discussion, talk about some of the objections you've been hearing about. You've posted a response article?
Yes.
Over at ChristopherCantwell.com addressing some of these objections, but we'll address some on the air here in moments. Our number 855-450-FREE. This is Free Talk Live.
Attention business owners. Do you know the three most critical letters in business?
CEO?
MBA?
Nope. Here's a hint. These three little letters can make the difference between making a fortune and losing everything.
ROI?
The answer is INC, as in incorporation. Because if you're not incorporated and someone sues your business, you can lose it all. Your home, your car, even your life savings. That's why Incorporate.com is now giving away a free incorporation guide to all business owners, so you can incorporate in just 10 minutes. Protect your home. Protect your car. Protect your life savings. Call 1-800-941-1029 for your free 10-minute incorporation guide from Incorporate.com. They don't provide legal or financial advice. They just make incorporating or forming an LLC quick and easy. Get the three little letters that can mean the difference between making a fortune and losing everything. For your free guide, call 1-800-941-1029. That's 1-800-941-1029.
We all know that Berkey water purification systems are the most trusted name in water filtration. As an authorized Berkey dealer for over 6 years and serving thousands of satisfied customers, the Berkey guy offers amazing specials for Berkey water filtration systems. The Berkey light systems include a set of self-sterilizing and recleanable black purification elements that purify water by removing chlorine, pathogenic bacteria, cysts, and parasites to non-detectable levels and remove harmful chemicals such as herbicides and pesticides. Order the Berkey light system today, complete with two black Berkey elements for only $231, and the Berkey guy will ship your order free of charge. With the purchase of a Berkey light, the Berkey guy is also offering a set of fluoride and arsenic filters for only $39.99. That's over 30% off the retail price. Call the Berkey guy at 1-877-886-3653. That's 1-877-886-3653. Or order online at goberkey.com. That's goberkey.com today.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world, so I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com. If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.FM Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
Hey, it's Free Talk Live. You may dial to join us here on the radio waves at 855-450-FREE. And if you like what we're doing on Free Talk Live, you can go to our website and you can contribute to the AMP program. AMP stands for Advertise, Market, and Promote. And the idea is you send $5 a month with any major credit card via PayPal or use Visa or MasterCard right on our website. You send $5 a month in to Free Talk Live, and we take that and invest it into the show so we can get on more radio stations, so we can bring more internet listeners on board with the program, expand our satellite coverage, and bring new people to the ideas of freedom. So if that's valuable to you, if it's worth $5 a month, you get perks too, like access to the AMP-only call-in lines, the AMP-only Facebook group, and more. Go to, once again, amp.freetalklive.com. That's amp.freetalklive.com. From ChristopherCantwell.com, the title of the big article is "I Almost Killed Somebody Last Night." The newest article on your site, Chris, is the one where you're refuting some of the critiques, because this has blown up big time, not just within the Liberty community, but also probably the gun rights community and the gun control community and, you know, all over the place. You've had over 500,000 views, you said, to the video so far. You can see this video over at ChristopherCantwell.com, where you were confronted by some people in the streets of downtown Keene. You pulled your gun on them. These psychos were coming after you because you were recording video of what you thought were two women who were being harassed by some men on the street. Now, you pull your gun, screaming at them, and I don't think we can play it on the air because
you can't.
It is not airworthy or air friendly. We could play it, but we'd have to bleep it.
Yeah.
You were screaming at these guys to get it through their heads that they were about to get shot, right?
Right. They were unaware of the severity of the situation is what scared the life out of me.
Did they seem to even realize you had a gun in your hand?
They knew I had the gun because they did immediately stop their advance when they saw the gun. Uh-huh. You can hear in the video, one guy says, "Dude, put that away."
Oh.
And I'm like, well, again, your advice is not terribly helpful. I'm sorry. You're a violent, raging lunatic in the street, and I'm pointing a gun at you. But at one point, these guys, they started to come closer, and I was like, "Are you kidding me? I'm pointing a gun at you." He says to me, "You're not gonna shoot me. You're not a cop, bro." I'm like, "Oh my god, this guy doesn't understand that I'm gonna kill him." And they wouldn't go away, right? Like in my mind, you know, this I have four threats in front of me and five bullets in my gun,
mm-hmm.
and I am looking at these people and I'm saying, "Go get in your car, get out of here," and they would not go away. Until the KPD showed up.
So
what happened when the KPD showed up?
Yeah, how long was it between when you pulled the gun and KPD rolled up?
It was less than 2 minutes. It was inside of 2 minutes. It was an extraordinarily fast response, and they showed up. And I'll say, like, that was really the most terrifying part of the whole ordeal, of course, right? Because I'm the guy who wrote "Violently Overthrow the Government" and "Gabby Giffords Begs for Another Bullet" and all of these really, scarily titled things about police and government. And I have a gun pointed at people, and I am terrified that I am going to wind up full of holes, gasping for air, dying an utterly meaningless death in the middle of the street.
Had this been Long Island, New York, you may very well. You likely would have, right? You'd be dead man.
I certainly would have. If I lived through it, I'd certainly be in prison because, having a carry permit in New York is not the easiest of things to do.
Right.
So, as it turned out, I mean, they didn't even point their guns at me. They approached the scene very rapidly, but were absolutely not only courteous and professional, but calm. I was amazed by the calm demeanor of the officers. Because, you know, they were arriving in the middle of the scene of a violent crime where a man has a gun out, and they, walked up to me and told me to relax. They asked permission to take my gun, and I said, "Yes, please take my gun.
Oh, wow.
I don't want to be a threat to you," and said, I'm going to pat your pockets, okay? I said, "Okay, go ahead, pat my pockets. Just let's, you know," and I told them, I said, "I know this is serious. I'm not screwing around with you guys, because look, we have antagonized police in Keene, New Hampshire, right?" Mm-hmm. I mean, this happens, you know, from time to time, and I'm, you know, wanted them to know that I was treating this with the, you know, this situation with the utmost seriousness. And they were courteous, kind, and professional. And I'm told that they took one of the guys into PC, which I presume
protective custody,
because it seemed that they were wasted and acting crazy. I mean, when you come towards a man with a gun pointed at your chest, I mean, that's probably right. Some sign of mental instability, drug-induced or otherwise. You're not okay,
mm-hmm.
you know. So it was amazing to me just how well the police had handled it. And it's funny that, you know, especially as of late, I've actually been on a really bad anti-police tear on my website, because I felt as though Stefan Molyneux had not sort of addressed some of the recent police brutality issues to my satisfaction. So I decided to ramp it up and do things in the sort of, shall we say, flamboyant way that I address issues. And so my website, the front page of my website, was like covered with just all anti-cop stuff. And then I have to go and say,
thanks, KPD.
Thank you for coming to help me. Yeah. Now, the truth of the matter is, at that moment in time, I wouldn't have cared if it was Murray Rothbard or Adolf Hitler who came to help me. I just wanted the conflict to end, you know.
Sure.
And so they did, and they were very good about it.
You know, I think that's I think it's interesting, especially watching you go through this, not what happened per se. I'm sorry you had to go through that, but to go through the process of realizing that the cops, at least the very least in Keene, I mean, I can't speak for Manchester or some of the other areas of New Hampshire, but at least the Keene police, I've always said this, but for a long time, I've said this about them, that they are a cut above the average cops out there. I really believe that's true. Now, that doesn't mean they don't have problems. That doesn't mean they're not out there, you know, hurting peaceful people, like arresting cannabis users or telling our friend Derek J that he can't have a concealed weapons permit because he's unsuitable. There are issues that they have. There's no doubt about
that. There's a lot of issues with them, and they have imprisoned people that I care about, and that makes me look at them as my enemies, and I have told them that quite plainly. However, you know, when they do a right thing, I certainly don't have any problem mentioning it, and I'd have no business criticizing police if I was not going to be honest about my interactions with them.
Right, and that's how I felt about it, is when they're doing the wrong thing, I'm going to tell them they're doing the wrong thing, and when they're doing the right thing, which every now and then they do, you know, they will go after an actual criminal here and there. I will say thank you, and I will say I appreciate it when you guys go out there and you do the right thing and go after actual criminals. And in this case, they're showing themselves to be calm in a scene where they would have reason to be crazy, right?
Yeah.
Like in a lot of police rolling up on that set, they'd pull guns on everybody and they'd, you know, shoot anybody that moved.
Yeah.
And they didn't do that, which is interesting. It was really interesting, too, when you mentioned that, because when you watch the video at ChristopherCantwell.com, again, the phone goes down when the gun comes out. And so there's no video for a period of time in the footage. And so all you get is audio, and you hear you saying that you're putting the gun down. So one would jump to the conclusion that you were being ordered to put the gun down and or being held at gunpoint. But in point of fact, you were not held
right.
at gunpoint.
What actually happened, because I got very scared, because one of my attackers goes to the police, and you could hear it on the video. He goes, "He's got a gun. He's got a gun." And I'm like, I'm going to die. This is what I'm thinking. That, you know, police are running up. They're coming up on the scene. They know who I am. They are entirely too familiar with
me. Call you by your first name.
The guy who wrote violently overthrow the government is pointing a gun at somebody, and there are nervous, crying people standing there. Yeah. And if they had decided to kill me, very few people would have even blinked at that.
Very few people would have witnessed it as well. Yep. And
they'd have had the video because they had the camera.
They could have made up whatever story they wanted to. So it is a real complimentary article towards the Keene police. And, you know, I don't have any distaste for most of the people on the Keene police. I find most of them to be folks that you can interact with, that you can talk to, you can have a conversation with. And I think they're more human-like because of that. And I think the fact that they're a small department, there's only 40, I think, uniformed officers in Keene police. That means that it's easier to know who all of them are. They certainly know who you are.
Yeah.
In fact, all of the Keene police likely know who you are by first name and will know you on site. You won't necessarily know who all of them are, but it's at least possible to know who most of them are. You'll encounter them over and over again. And so it's inevitable that you'll build relationships with them. I know when I came here to Keene as part of the Free State Project back in 2006, been almost a decade, that I was also very jaded towards police, and I thought police were bad guys. I went on a Keene police ride-along, actually, not too long after I moved here with Lieutenant Shane Maxfield, who's still with the department and I believe still holds that rank as lieutenant. It was about an hour long. It was me and Sam Dodson, who was a co-host on Free Talk Live for a while, and my girlfriend at the time. We were in the one of their SUVs, and we had an excellent conversation with him about ending the war on drugs, which he supports, and a variety of other issues, self-defense and gun ownership was in there as well. And I recommended to you, Chris, that you check that out. I don't know if you've had a chance to yet.
No, I should.
But let's talk more about what's coming next, because you might actually be going out on a date with a Keene police officer here.
What?
No, well, not an actual, like, relationship.
Oh, okay.
No,
I've lost track of everything.
You've got a coffee date, maybe. It's Free Talk Live. More coming up.
In a trial by jury, the primary function of a juror is not to dispense punishment to the accused. It is to protect your fellow citizens from being unjustly deprived of their life, liberty, or property. As a juror, you can say no to unjust laws and prevent government abuses of power by refusing to convict. Legislative, executive, judicial. The fourth branch of government is we the people. Find out more from the Fully Informed Jury Association at fija.org.
Indefinite extension of the human lifespan is coming. But is it coming soon enough for you and me? That's the $80,000 question. I say $80,000 because that's what it costs to have your head cryonically frozen by Alcor. I've committed to do it. I got a life insurance policy, and I made them the beneficiaries. Bam. My best shot at living forever. Interested? Contact them at alcor.org. ALCOR.ORG. Mention my name, and I get a free year of membership.
Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road Underground Market. The Silk Road was a gift to humanity and helped reduce the harms brought on by drug prohibition. For this good deed, Ross may be spending the rest of his life in prison. His family is planning to appeal his conviction, but they need your support. Please visit FreeRoss.org, where you can contribute via various methods, including Bitcoin. Ross needs your help now more than ever. Visit FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. facebook.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Wednesday, May 13th, 2015. Silver is trading at $16.95 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,203 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $245. Antiwar.com reports 6 weeks into their aerial campaign, and after 48 hours of severe escalation, Saudi Arabia has announced a temporary halt to their airstrikes against Yemen, the beginning of what they say will be a five-day humanitarian pause. There is skepticism, but also a lot of hope among Yemeni civilians who are hoping their cities won't be bombed over the next few days, and hoping even more that the Saudi naval blockade will begin allowing humanitarian aid into the country. While fighting picked up, particularly along the border in the hours leading up to the 11 p.m. deadline, residents of Yemeni cities have reported no incidents in the first couple of hours since. Saudi military commanders say that despite the pause, they will continue overflights of Yemen for surveillance purposes and will resume strikes if they believe the Houthis are violating the terms of the deal, which includes that none of their troops move for the next 5 days. For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. UPI reports a 7.3 magnitude earthquake struck Nepal on Tuesday, just weeks after another earthquake devastated parts of the nation and killed more than 8,000 people. At least 37 people were killed and more than 1,000 injured in the town of Chatara by the latest earthquake. At least 17 also died in India and one in Tibet.
A 6.3 magnitude aftershock followed shortly after Tuesday's quake. The earthquake occurred about 50 miles east of Kathmandu, the country's capital. The latest quake struck at a depth of 9 miles, and Nepal is still recovering from the magnitude 7.8 earthquake that struck the central part of the country on April 25th, leading to thousands of deaths and 17,000 injured. The effects of the latest quake were felt in Kathmandu, but there were no reports of significant damage there. The Save the Children charity said teams were assessing the impact on buildings that had already been damaged and told USA Today, "It's a terrifying time for the hundreds of thousands of children and families who lost everything in the April 25th earthquake." Meanwhile, a U.S. Marines helicopter conducted disaster relief missions in Nepal went missing on Tuesday. ExpressCoin is the best choice for buying Bitcoin, Litecoin, Dogecoin, and more. ExpressCoin prides themselves on their customer service, so much so that the back end on the website should allow them to be even more focused on your needs. Get your cryptocurrencies with money order, check, wire transfer, or cash deposit. Get started at expresscoin.fppradio.com. That's expresscoin.fppradio.com. Reuters reports Texas on Tuesday executed a man convicted of murdering his girlfriend, her mother, and grandfather in their Houston home in 2002 as he took revenge on the family for trying to cut off his relationship with the daughter. Derek Charles was announced dead at 6:36 p.m. Central Time after receiving a lethal injection at the state's death chamber in Huntsville, according to prison officials. Charles, who strangled all three, was the 525th inmate executed in Texas since the U.S. Supreme Court reinstated the death penalty in 1976, with the state accounting for 37% of all executions in the country during the time. The U.S. Supreme Court denied a petition seeking to halt the execution. Lawyers for Charles had argued that he was mentally incompetent and could not legally be subject to capital punishment. At the time of the crime, Charles was 19 and out on parole for burglary. Prosecutors said he sought revenge on Brenda Bennett because she was trying to stop her underage daughter, Maisha, from having sex with Charles. Charles hid in the family home and first beat Obi Bennett with a lamp and trophies. The grandfather was found in the kitchen with an electrical cord around his neck, according to prosecutors and the Texas Attorney General. He then waited for Brenda and Maisha to come home. When they arrived, he bound and gagged them. According to prosecutors, he killed Maisha and sexually assaulted and strangled her mother. He pled guilty to the crime and was later sentenced to death. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Clark County paramedics responded to a frantic 911 call from a nearby motel this morning, where the Lord our God, divine creator and ruler of the universe, had been found nude and unconscious following his latest suicide attempt. God, who sources say had recently grown far more depressed and withdrawn from humanity than usual, reportedly attempted to hang himself from the base of his motel showerhead after ingesting an unknown quantity of Ambien. Motel sources claim that God's room had been left in a state of disarray and revealed that they had found a brief note written by the omnipotent deity saying that the suicide stems from long periods of unhappiness he had been suffering in recent millennia, including the death of his only child, thousands of years of war and genocide, chronic weight gain, and the aftermath of his messy 15,088 BC. Divorce. Paramedics say the Supreme Being had no pulse when they arrived. The Lord's overdose comes in the wake of several widely publicized previous suicide attempts, including a 1985 incident when the Lord leapt from the Grand Canyon but changed into a bird at the last second and flew to safety.
This is the Onion News Network.
Welcome back to Free Talk Live. We got Chris Cantwell in the studio with Ian and Mark. As usual, our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We're going to begin dissecting a little bit here some of the critiques of Chris Cantwell's actions a few nights ago in the streets of Keene, New Hampshire, where he pulled a gun on some people who were threatening him with who knows what. They luckily did not reach you with their threats. They came close, and right. You managed to stop them. The police arrived within 2 minutes and intervened and managed to, you know, take these scumbags out from your purview, and they let you go. They reviewed the footage that you had recorded on your cell phone, and basically said, you're fine. You didn't catch any criminal charges whatsoever from this incident of you defending yourself here in Keene, New Hampshire.
Right, exactly. And I had explained to the officers that I was not asking them to pursue anything against my attackers. I really, you know, I would have seen, I would have been justified to do that, but I did not seek any retribution against them. I just wanted the conflict to end, and we all walked away except for one guy who got taken into protective custody.
Because he was S-faced.
Because he was crazy. I don't know what drugs he might have been under the influence of. I have
usually
no idea.
Usually PC is for people really drunk, but who knows? I'm sure they can PC people for different reasons. So this was posted to ChristopherCantwell.com. The video, the article that you wrote up explaining your experience and kind of lauding the Keene police for doing the right thing in this circumstance. Yeah. They really got it right. They were cool, calm, collected, and they handled the situation ideally. You handled the situation well as well. In fact, some of your critics have said that you handled the situation very well.
Yeah,
Michael Dean from Freedom Fiends. He gave you compliments. Garrett Ian, who's one of the Robin Hooders in here in Keene, another activist in the area. You two have had some conflicts in the past. Yeah. He said that you gained a few slots in his book as a result of how you handled yourself in that situation.
Yeah. One of the funniest things about this whole ordeal has been in the aftermath that people who I would probably expect to be in my corner in this incident were turning against me, while people who
really?
Were my most vehement enemies prior lauded my restraint. And
so were the people who turning against you, were they the ones who wanted you to blast away and shoot these people?
There was some amount of that. I haven't taken that very seriously. Anybody who tells me, oh, you when you pull your gun, you gotta kill somebody, and I'm like, look, I was absolutely prepared to kill somebody. It really almost happened. However, if I can stop the threat without killing somebody, I will. I have never in my life wanted so badly not to kill someone as I did in the moment that I'm pointing a gun at a man's chest. I mean,
thank goodness.
I have violent impulses, right? Like, it occurs to me at times, like, hey, I don't know, maybe I should bash that guy's head open. I mean, this goes through my head from time to time. People make me angry, and I have violent impulses. But I did not want in that moment to, you know, to end this guy's life, and I was furious with him for making me think that I was going to have to.
I think that's really an awesome thing to say, and I think it shows that you have empathy towards these people, even though they were definitely, you know, not empathizing with you on that particular evening, that they were a threat to you. They certainly could have hurt you and done who knows what to you, and yet you restrained yourself from going ahead and hurting them when you could have been fully justified in doing so, right?
Yeah, but I mean, at the moment that the gun is justified to come out, the gun is justified to fire, mm-hmm. okay? If I am justified in pulling a gun on you, it is because you are already a threat to my safety,
right.
And thus I will end lives to protect myself. I am not screwing around. I will respond with lethal force to somebody who wants to do harm to me. I have a gun on my hip, and I cannot engage in fisticuffs with you and risk you getting control of my weapon. If violent, dangerous lunatics are attacking me in the street, I cannot trust them to be in control of my gun, and I will thus end lives before I allow that to happen.
Let's talk about some of the critiques. So one I heard about, and I haven't read your response article, so I'm certainly not aware of all of the critiques, but one of the ones I heard about, ostensibly coming from a libertarian, was that it's somehow aggression to take someone's photo in public.
Well, that's just patently ridiculous. I mean,
is that one of them, though? Is that what somebody said?
There was criticism of me recording. So there's two complaints about me recording. One is that I just should have minded my own business and not gone over there in the first place. The other is that upon being told I should stop recording, that I should stop. Right now, you can't hear what happens before I start recording. Right,
mm-hmm.
I hear voices, and those voices, the intonation of those voices, tell me that someone's in danger.
Angry men, crying women.
Yes.
Right?
And I am saying to myself, that's a dangerous situation that I might be able to de-escalate by recording, because we do this on a regular basis. I have recorded dozens of traffic stops and different interactions with people. In the case of traffic stops, I use the example in my article that I have recorded traffic stops where a cop just lets somebody off with a warning because he doesn't want to be seen giving somebody a ticket. Okay. And so people have a tendency to behave better when they are being recorded because they do not want their bad behavior shown to other people.
Sometimes, unless they are completely irrational, as these people
unless
were.
Unless they are violent, dangerous lunatics who attack cameramen in the street. So, I go over there with the hope that I will prevent people from getting hurt. This does not pan out now that they're telling me to stop recording them. Why do I not stop recording when I am commanded to stop recording? Well, if there are violent, dangerous, crazy people in the street who don't want me to record them while they are being violent and dangerous and crazy, I am not surprised by that opinion, and I hold it at near zero value. I am not taking advice from dangerous, violent lunatics out on the street at 3 in the morning. I think that this is a dangerous situation that deserves to be recorded, which provides an impartial, transparent record of events. This is the best evidence that I can provide should something go wrong.
And you did provide that evidence. Likely, if you hadn't been able to provide that evidence, you would not have walked away from there like you did.
I mean,
you'd have been he was a man with a gun on the street, and who knows what conclusions the police would have come to. They would have had, frankly, no one would have argued with them taking Cantwell to jail if he hadn't have had that objective proof as to what happened.
I wouldn't have argued with them about it. If I planned on being taken into custody. I couldn't believe that I pulled a gun out on people and I was given my gun back and sent home. I was absolutely astonished by this. So I would totally expect it to have been taken into custody even with the video.
Welcome to New Hampshire.
But the video absolutely cleared me, and these guys are saying, hey, don't record this. Well, you just made me pull a gun out on you. It's a good thing I was recording because I might be in prison right now had I not recorded. Now, you could say that they only attacked me because I was recording, but these are violent, dangerous, crazy people in the street at 3 a.m., and I can't trust them to behave rationally.
I want to go to Ken. He's on the line in Minnesota listening to WNMT. Hello, Ken.
Yes. I'd like to ask your guest, what can I do to get people to watch a video? I called in last night about the video on YouTube, Healing Kimmy Yours, and I actually got 14 views. And I was wondering if he could give me some insight on what I can do better to get people to watch this video.
Don't be boring, I think would be number one. And I'm not saying your video's boring, I haven't watched it. But I can tell you that, a video about how you can heal yourself through the power of Jesus, which is the summary of what he called about last night, isn't going to likely go viral. It's not likely to make news headlines. And Chris Cantwell, you got news coverage from NH1.com as a result of this. I don't know who else has contacted you.
Yeah, I'm willing to bet that my video raised a lot more pulses than healing yourself through the power of Jesus. But what I would say is the way that you get the video to be viewed is to get the video in front of groups of people who have similar interests, right? So I put this out there, and I am already tapped into a market of gun rights activists, mm-hmm. right? So they're going to see I'm in a self-defense scenario. It's an exciting and compelling video, and they want to share it with other people, and the video goes viral and gets, half a million views plus. Most of my videos don't see that, though. I mean, I'm usually lucky. I'm excited if my video gets over 1,000 hits. Very few of my videos do that. So, it's all a matter of the content. If the content is compelling and people are interested in it, they will share it, and then you will get views. But if it's not, then it's going to sit there and collect dust.
Good luck, Ken. Thanks for the call. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. I mean, I put out videos on the Free Keene YouTube channel that I feel like, are great content. But just because you put out great content doesn't necessarily mean that it's going to catch, that it's going to be widely shared and go viral. In your case, your video had everything that it needed, essentially. It had it had drama, it had confrontation, it had a gun, although the gun you can't actually see in the footage, I don't think.
Yeah, you can't.
But it had
camera
you yelling
gets dropped when the gun comes out.
Yeah. So
you can still hear it.
Yeah, and it was an unusual situation that ended in an unusual fashion because it happened in New Hampshire and not a lot of these other places. It's Free Talk Live.
There are two types of advertising.
poll advertising like Google AdWords, where a consumer goes looking for widgets near them and you try to pull them in with your ad away from the other widget purveyors. Then there's push advertising, where you push your message out about your great widgets and attempt to convince people who weren't thinking about widgets at all that what they need in their life right now is your widget. Radio is push advertising. In the course of a week, there are probably over 250,000 good folks listening to Free Talk Live, and they could hear your message. We're having a sale right now, and it ends May 15th. 200 30-second ads for $1,997. That's like 10 bucks an ad. Find another show with that kind of rate with 150-plus stations. Email me, markedge@freetalklive.com, and I'll set you up. You don't need to have an ad. We'll produce it for you. Buy 200 30-second ads by May 15th and get them for less than $10 a piece. It's a big savings, and you don't want to miss it. Email me, mark@freetalklive.com now. This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938, 877-357-9938.
Farmers keep livestock lean and healthy with a mineral-rich diet. Then, before market, they cut off minerals, leaving them to crave high-calorie grains. If weight control is this easy, why prescribe surgery for humans? Introducing Youngevity. You could avoid 900 diseases by getting 90 essential nutrients from Youngevity. Check out 90 for Life at tobeyoungagain.com or call 855-79-YOUNG. That's 855-79-YOUNG or tobeyoungagain.com. Youngevity. It's all about saving money, getting healthy, and creating wealth.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. Physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com. So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm. LRN.fm needs your help getting our satellite signal back on in Africa. Our satellite provider had us on at no charge from 2012 through February of this year when they pulled the channel off the air. Now we're trying to raise $22,000 to continue reaching people with the message of liberty in places where it's needed most. Please visit our Indiegogo fundraiser at africa.lrn.fm. Give what you can and share the link with your friends. africa.lrn.fm.
Listen to LRN.FM on any phone, anytime. 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309.
We are back with more Free Talk Live. Join us here on the air at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Also, you can join us via Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. And maybe you've got a product, service, or something you want us to promote for you. We can help you with that.
Yeah, we're having a sale. It's going on till the end of the week, so you're going to have to get a hold of me pretty quick.
And by end of the week, you mean Friday.
Yep, Friday. Close of business, basically, is my plan. We are selling, you know, really great deal. You can get 230 second ads for $1,997. It's like 10 bucks an ad. And you're not going to be able to find that anywhere else on any other station that's on, or any other show that's on 150 stations across the country. So there you go. Just get a hold of me, Mark at freetalklive.com.
All right, we'll continue here a little bit more about what happened with Chris Cantwell on the streets of Keene, where he had to pull his gun and managed to walk away. No handcuffs, no criminal charges. You pulled a gun, defended yourself, and the police backed you on this.
They sure did.
It was a refreshing change for you. You thought that this was, you know, when the police rolled up, you were worried you were going to end up with bullet wounds as a result of the situation.
I was nearly certain of it.
And turns out you're in New Hampshire, and things operate a little bit differently here than they do in places like New York, California, Illinois, and other hellholes where gun rights are not respected and the police hate your freedoms when it comes to carrying guns. In New Hampshire, the cops actually, a lot of them like guns, and they're more likely to, if a cop stops you on the streets of New Hampshire and asks about your gun, it's genuinely usually because they're interested in knowing what kind of gun you're carrying and how you like it, and, you know, does it shoot well? You know, are you enjoying it? Lots of the cops here are really cool with guns, which is a good thing.
Yeah, certainly.
So if you want to learn more about living in New Hampshire and why it's a great idea, I would recommend the 101 Reasons that Liberty Lives in New Hampshire. If you care about freedom, if you love the state and you love to be obedient and being told what to do, and you love telling other people what to do, this is not the right place for you. But if you love liberty and you want to be more free in your lifetime, go to 101reasonsfilm.com. Check out the 101 reasons that you should consider moving to New Hampshire. 101reasonsfilm.com. As we go to your calls and thoughts, Cole is listening in Anchorage. Cole, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, how you doing?
Hey, what's on your mind?
I wanted to call and kind of touch somewhat on a subject you guys talked about last night with smuggling birds illegally. And it's a question I've had for you guys, see what your take is. I consider myself a libertarian, and I also consider myself an environmentalist. I love trees more than anybody else, you know. But I certainly don't want the government to get involved in anything that would be considered environmentalism. So what can I do as a libertarian to help protect the environment and stop things like birds getting smuggled and water bottles?
I think Mark had a good idea the other night. You can buy some of the environment, like groups like the Audubon Society and Ducks Unlimited. You can actually, you know, put your money and your capital into purchasing land and then protecting the little critters that are on that land. That's one way to do it. Another way would be to lobby politically to lessen regulations on owning and trading and selling animals, I would think. Mark, well, any suggestions?
I would specialize those that lobbying. I'm not entire. If the world's going to have these monopoly organizations called states, I would say that the you know, some of the few things that they do that I have some kind of support for is that they, you know, they say you can't you know, hunt wild endangered animals. That's fine and dandy, but the problem is that when they make it illegal to trade in certain items, like in this case, I don't know what the rules are specifically on these yellow crested cockatoos, but if they make it difficult for me to sell them in other countries or across state lines, or that you can't sell them at all, or, you know, there's some kind of licensing or these kind of things, if they drive up the costs of domestically bred birds, and that then opens up the marketplace for the wild caught birds that we don't want caught.
Right. I guess I would say, what can I do on a small scale? Because for me, I guess I could donate to a group like Ducks Unlimited, but I can't go out and necessarily start buying up the rainforest.
Yeah.
Because I just don't have the capital, whereas I might be able to do a little bit of something, maybe donate. So
find organizations that have a mission that you agree with and get behind them.
You can also propagandize. I mean, spreading information
that's
on social
important
media, that sort of thing. I mean, you know, if you're not in a position to go out and actually do some of the things that you feel need to be done, the way to the best way to do that is to support the people who are able to do them. Now, whether you do that financially, as I always encourage people to do at ChristopherCantwell.com/donate, or whether it is for you to just spread the information, share articles and videos on, you know, Facebook or Reddit or whatever, those are extraordinarily helpful ways ways of, you know, amplifying the message of people who are taking the action you seek to see taken.
Okay, thank you. Thanks. I really appreciate the answer, guys.
Thanks,
Cole. And if I could just throw one more thing in here.
Yeah.
That's all right.
Go ahead.
Just because you guys are talking about it tonight, I got pulled over just the other day. I was actually a passenger, and I was carrying my firearm, concealed carrying, and the police officer came to my window in addition to the driver's window, and I informed him in Alaska it's your duty to inform the officer as they're pulling you over.
Interesting.
And because of that, they didn't give us a ticket or anything, and they said they really appreciated us doing that. So I know.
Do they have that in New Hampshire?
We don't have a duty to inform. No,
that's good to know. Now, Alaska does have better rights as far as, like, you can concealed carry without a permit?
Constitutional carry, yeah. They have that there, I'm pretty sure.
Yes. Yeah, you can carry without a permit. The only reason you get a permit here is if you're traveling out of state and
right.
You go to a state that requires a permit.
I see. So they still have one that they can issue if you want them to.
For the purpose of reciprocation. Yeah, I mean, we were thinking about a bill. There was a consideration of a bill in New Hampshire to basically make us like that.
Maggie Hassan veto that?
I don't know if it has yet been vetoed, but my understanding is that she had pledged to veto the bill.
Yeah, she had pledged it. I also agree. I haven't heard any news as to whether or not that has happened yet. Cole, thanks for the story. Appreciate hearing from you tonight. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Let's go to Benjamin in California via Skype. Hey, Benjamin.
Hey.
Hey, what's on your mind?
So this situation with Cantwell, the video, I saw it a couple days ago. I read his initial article on it, and it reminded me of a situation I had a couple years ago. I don't remember when it was, where I was in a parking lot across the street from a bar, like a couple hundred feet, and I saw a man and a woman outside of the bar yelling at each other. Like, at first they were just kind of yelling a little bit, but it slowly kept escalating up and up and up. I kept watching these people while I was waiting for a friend, and trying to decide what I was going to do. My phone didn't have enough power to go out and video it. At the time, I wasn't carrying my firearm because I was dealing with court stuff. But I was like, well, I'm not going to call the police. There's no reason to call the police. But it kept escalating up until the point where it started getting physical. And at that point, I did choose to call the police because I wasn't going to go and get in a physical altercation with these people. Mm-hmm. And the police were going to arrive anyways, I'm sure, had it kept escalating. So I decided to call the police.
Well, let's talk about that here in a moment. Was that the right thing to do? What, you know, your justification for it? Because some people are going to jump on you. They're going to say, oh, you're a cop caller. And it's like act as though it's always a bad thing to call the police. I think it's something you should be cautious about, but they are the only protection service out there that we've got. It's Free Talk Live. We're coming up.
By now you know that wireless technology like cell phones do in fact pose dangers to the health and privacy of everyone. Blockit Pocket's wide range of products are unmatched in providing the protection you deserve. No scare tactics, just common sense. BlockitPocket.com offers quality American-made options to alleviate and eliminate these invisible dangers. Learn more at BlockitPocket.com or call 888-315-9618. BlockitPocket.com, enhancing health and privacy.
So I say to Mark at lunch, look, you know, I keep hearing from the government that, you know, they're worried someday ISIS may get here. And I go, duh, Garland, Texas, Muhammad cartoon shooting, ISIS is already here. I'm not waiting for these people to defend me. If they don't know ISIS is here already, they got no clue, I'm taking care of myself. Guns80.com, AR-15 kits, 30-shot magazines, great prices. They've even got the Hillary special. Guns80.com, that's 844-2-GUNS-80, Guns80.com.
If you're looking for work, you know what I mean by elevator speech. It's the short version, saying just enough to make the listener want to listen more. Even if you're not a job seeker, effective communication skills have never been more important with money and attention so scarce now. So to cut through the clutter, choose every single word as though it was the last word the person you're speaking to will hear. Otherwise, it might be. Instead of saying, due to the fact that, say, because, and avoid mispronunciations. Say jewelry, not jewelry, which could offend. Undoubtedly, you don't want to say undoubtedly. And whatever you do, never use a preposition to end a sentence with. Just kidding. For more tips, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
My name is Jacob Hornberger. I'm president of the Future of Freedom Foundation, which Congressman Ron Paul awarded for having an outstanding freedom website. Write us at fff@fff.org, and we'll send you a free 3-month subscription to our monthly journal of libertarian essays and our booklet, Economic Liberty in the Constitution, which George Mason University economics professor Walter Williams praised in a recent column. That's FFF at FFF.org.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
There are two types of advertising. Pull advertising, like Google AdWords, where a consumer goes looking for widgets near them and you try to pull them in with your ad away from the other widget purveyors. Then there's push advertising, where you push your message out about your great widgets and attempt to convince people who weren't thinking about widgets at all that what they need in their life right now is your widget. Radio is push advertising. In the course of a week, there are probably over 250,000 good folks listening to Free Talk Live, and they could hear your message. We're having a sale right now, and it ends May 15th. 200 30-second ads for $1,997. That's like 10 bucks an ad. Find another show with that kind of rate with 150-plus stations. Email me, markedge@freetalklive.com, and I'll set you up. You don't need to have an ad. We'll produce it for you. Buy 200 30-second ads by May 15th and get them for less than $10 a piece. It's a big savings, and you don't want to miss it. Email me, mark@freetalklive.com, now.
You can interact with other LRN listeners in our message board at forum.lrn.fm. That's forum.lrn.fm.
We're back with more Free Talk Live. Plenty of time for you to call in, share your thoughts with us here. 855-450-FREE, whether it's on the viral video available over at ChristopherCantwell.com where he pulls a gun on some psychos in the streets of Keene, New Hampshire to defend himself against these nutcases, or whatever you want to talk about here. 855-450-FREE is our number. We've also got Skype. The Skype username is lrn.fm. Did you know that Free Talk Live has a YouTube channel? Well, now you do. You go to youtube.freetalklive.com. That'll jump you straight to our YouTube URL where you can download full episodes of Free Talk Live. We're talking 3 hours of show, unedited. We just throw it up there. And you can download them and use them for whatever purpose you want. Chris, you actually download and then edit them into clips, and you upload them to your own channel.
I have not been doing as much of that recently.
You have done that, though.
Yeah, I have done that before. And if you you are a fan of a particular segment on here, go ahead and contact me. If you go to ChristopherCantwell.com/contact, somebody actually called into Radical Agenda and suggested that I begin doing it again. Mm. If there's a particular segment of the show that you would like to see clipped out and uploaded, I will do that for next to nothing, for nothing at all. I'm just going to put it up on the channel and then you can see it and share it with your friends. But when I was doing it, I was putting up like every segment of the show, and they were getting very high hit counts, and it was making me fear for a phenomenon on YouTube called subscriber burnout, where people
you don't want to have too much.
Yeah, you put too much content in there, and then people are like, "I'm not watching this channel," and then you fall off their front page. Not a good thing.
Yeah, better to be choosy about what you put up than scattershot, I guess.
Yeah.
So we've got Benjamin with us here in California. He's on via Skype. And Benjamin, you were talking about an incident in the streets in California, which was escalating. You were observing this incident. You weren't a party to it. And you decided to call in the police. Is that right?
Yeah, I wasn't like looking forward to it. And I didn't jump on it. Mm-hmm. I sat there and watched them for like 15 minutes at least, watching how it kept escalating. And as long as the the armed bureaucrats claim a monopoly, I wasn't going to go interfere. I didn't want to get in a physical altercation. I wasn't armed. I wasn't prepared for that kind of thing at the time. And so I reluctantly called 911.
I don't blame you for that. I mean, look, I'm not going to stop spending Federal Reserve notes or driving on roads or going to doctors just because I live under a brutal, oppressive regime of a government, right? I'm going to go and acquire those services. So why I would be forced out of the protection, security, and dispute resolution market just because the government had violently monopolized those services is foundationally ridiculous.
Yeah. And Chris, by the way, I watched that video. I've watched it actually a few times. I have to say, I thought you did really well. There's always things we can all do, quote unquote, better in retrospect. But I think you, at the beginning of that encounter, you were calm. You kept a good voice. You didn't escalate your voice in your demeanor until you were aggressed upon, essentially. So I thought you did real well.
Thank,
for what it's worth.
Thank you, buddy. I really appreciate that.
What happened in your situation when the police showed up? Were you still there observing at that time?
I observed for a little bit. It just looked like they walked up on them and started talking to them. At that point, I had already been there a long time and I had to go.
Mm-hmm.
So I did. But
I think it's something that,
I don't know what happened to him.
I think that if you're going to call the police, it should be something that's very, very serious, and it should be something done with the utmost caution and concern for the people involved. Because when you call the cops, you may be making a situation worse. And that's the only concern that I have, is that, you know, this may have been a fight that, and again, I wasn't there. I don't know how serious it was. But
you said it was physical.
It did get physical?
Yeah, that's the old, I just sat there watching for the longest time, and they were just yelling at each other, and that kept escalating. But I was like, whatever, they're yelling at each other, big deal. I didn't call the armed bureaucrats until I saw the gentleman start pushing the woman.
Yeah, when you're looking at a violent confrontation, you know, that's a point where force becomes justified, right?
Yeah.
You can act with violence in defense of yourself or of others. And if you decide to outsource that responsibility to somebody else, then, you know, then you're more than welcome to do that, and I think you did the right thing, buddy.
But there are plenty of circumstances where calling the police could make a situation worse, especially a situation in which you don't have full information. So let's say you hear an argument happening in a neighbor's house. Then police get called on a situation like that. In a lot of jurisdictions, the police must arrest in a domestic dispute situation. So you may have taken what could have just been a verbal dispute between a couple and made it into an arrestable situation that makes the situation worse with those folks. So I think you always have to be very, very cautious to know that these aggressors, the people who are the police, aren't necessarily going to de-escalate a conflict. They're not all like trained as well as they are here in Keene, New Hampshire, elsewhere. So be careful.
That was the other thing that really impressed me with the video. In fact, when I posted the article and video on my Facebook, I started off with saying how I was impressed by the armed bureaucrats of the Keene Police Department. I was like, good on them. Like, you know, I'm willing to say when they do crap wrong, but if they're going to do good, I think that should be pointed out.
I would say if you know for a fact there is violence being used, that seems like a decent enough reason. But if you're not in possession of the facts, I would say I would err on the side of not calling, right? Like if you just hear an argument from next door and you don't know what's going on, it sounds serious, but you don't really know, I'd say leave that one alone.
Yeah, when you're talking about domestic disputes, it's one I would think when they pass these laws that says that, or these policies or whatever they are, that the police officer must arrest somebody if they go to a domestic.
Terrible rule.
Yeah,
terrible.
Well, I can see it if one of the people, one of the claimants, one of the people in the dispute makes the call, right? So, I mean, if you're going to make a call to the police, then you allegedly feel threatened enough that, that there should be something done about it. But if the neighbor calls, I don't see any particular reason why, because somebody felt the need to call the police, that you've just got to go out there and arrest somebody. That doesn't make any sense.
Benjamin, thanks for the call tonight. Appreciate hearing from you. Let's talk to James. He's in Kalamazoo. James, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian, Chris Cantwell, and Mark.
Hello. First off, Cantwell, I also contributed to a few of those watches on that video, and I also probably would have pulled out my firearm if I were in that situation. So, pretty scary stuff.
Thanks,
but the reason I'm calling is because... Well, I'm
starting to kind of do some activism here locally. I am a Free State Project participant, but I figured, you know, this being my hometown, I'm starting a, you know, a network, for example, through Liberty on the Rocks, as well as trying to get out there and, you know, just spread the message of liberty and, you know, what libertarian principles really are, because a lot of people are scared of them. They think that we're kooky. You know, they think that we're a cult. So anyway, one of the people that I've actually known for a while, and, you know, I started talking to him, and come to find out, he's a supporter of the Free State Project. He's not a participant, but he's a friend of the Free State Project, as well as an open carry activist here in Michigan. A lot of people here in Michigan seem to forget that we are an open carry state. So I decided to educate myself on the laws here because obviously I'm moving to New Hampshire, but I still have friends and family. I'm going to be coming back here, and I'd like to, you know, exercise my right, which, by the way, I found out that New York has some crazy laws when I was investigating. And I found a hole that I can't seem to figure out in the law. In Michigan, you have to register and license your pistol. If you have one, and I can't seem to, that is, so if somebody coming from another state has to show that state license, and what I can't get an answer on is, what if somebody's coming from a state that doesn't require that?
Normally what will happen is you could be protected by federal law if you're just transporting the weapon. If you put the weapon in your trunk in a locked box and the ammo is separate, then like federal law protects you as far as, you know, transporting the weapon through that state. But my understanding of it would be that you are not able to, you know, carry a gun in a place where you are required to have a permit to do so.
What I ended up doing, and I know by no means our law enforcement the experts on it, is I actually found a police officer walking around downtown, and I decided to ask him what he would do. And I asked his permission to video it. I told him, you know, that I'm starting a video blog, and for the purpose of informing
James,
people.
James, hang on. We'll let you finish the story in a moment. It's Free Talk Live at 855-450-FREE. More coming up.
I'm Steve Sitkowski, a former Wall Street insider. I'm holding a book that will show you investing strategies which could help you earn the kind of money you've always dreamed about. And right now, I'm giving this book away for free. So who needs to read it? If you're in the middle of your career and worry you'll never have enough money to retire, you need to read this book. If you're already retired and your income isn't enough, you need to read this book. And if you don't want to be selling burgers at 80, you need to read this free book. It includes the strategy I use to make a 72% profit on a trade where the stock only moved 12%. You'll need at least $1 million to ever fully retire. If you're behind on that goal, you really need to read Trade Like the Pros. And you can for free by calling 1-800-944-5836. Skeptical that it will deliver results? It's a free book, so what do you have to lose? Find out how at 1-800-944-5836. 1-800-944-5836.
It's time to build your own emergency food stockpile with the industry leader, My Patriot Supply. Once you try them, you'll know why so many Americans like you have made them part of their emergency preparedness plan. Experience the My Patriot Supply difference today with this unbelievable offer. Right now, a 4-week food supply is only $99, and that includes free shipping. That's 50% off the online price. Call 800-274-3070 to claim yours. Limit 2 per caller while supplies last. This offer isn't available online, so you want to make sure and grab this opportunity to get prepared today. 800-274-3070 to get your 4-week food supply for the incredible price of only $99, and it'll be shipped to you completely free. Call 800-274-3070 right now. That's 800-274-3070 to claim yours while supplies last. Don't wait. Call today.
Free Talk Live.
I'm sure I can speak for many of thousands. I don't fear illegals. I don't want them here and their filth that they bring with and the disease that they bring with.
All the people who work in the stores and the markets and the restaurants are overwhelmingly Hispanic, and they seem very clean and be doing a fine job here, and I've never heard anything about problems with disease.
For you to defend the illegal immigrants, and I'm not sure, as I said earlier, which host at what time is very condescending.
defending.
Madam, I will defend anybody that is peaceful and looking for a better life for themselves. We already pointed out.
I don't defend them. I wish that people like you.
You say that Mexicans are filthy and you call me condescending, lady? You say they're disease ridden and filthy and I'm condescending?
And they are.
You're outrageous.
Get her out of here.
Thank you for the call.
She's had all her rope. She's hung herself.
Free Talk Live. 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern. Live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com. This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. You can join us here in the remaining moments right now at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. With you in studio, it's Ian
Cantwell
and Mark.
Join us online at freetalklive.com. If you enjoy the show and you want to help support Free Talk Live, please donate to the African Satellite Fundraiser at africa.lrn.fm. It's going on for another 4 days, so we've got time for you to throw a few bucks in. If you've got them to spare, we'd appreciate it. It'll help us get our satellite signal back up over most of Africa. A good swath of it is covered by the Amos 5 satellite, and that'll result in millions of people having access to the signal that we put out there, which contains lots of great liberty-oriented shows, not just Free Talk Live, but dozens more shows are on LRN.FM. And the people in Africa, a lot of them don't even have internet access. So this is a way to reach those folks with a message of liberty that could, you know, help foment some, I don't know, revolutions or something, perhaps. You never know what these ideas will do for people. And if you want to help us make that happen, please go to africa.lrn.fm. There are some perks you can get in return for your contributions. Once again, that's africa.lrn.fm. We've got James with us here. Now, James, you're in Kalamazoo, Michigan, and you said you've been going out, you've been kind of working on putting together some activism. You put together a Liberty on the Rocks group, which is kind of like a social meetup for liberty-minded folks. And then you mentioned something about a gun permits in other states versus Michigan, and I'm sorry, I can't really recall exactly what you were trying to say there. You were wondering about states where there's there aren't permits required and people moving to Michigan.
Well, yeah, people visiting Michigan.
Visiting.
Based on what I read, if you're a visitor out of state, and of course they list that as somebody visiting for less than 180 days. If they're visiting, they just have to, and they're open carrying or even concealed carrying, they just have to provide the license from the other state. But there are states out there that don't require you to register your firearm.
Okay, I understand your confusion there. And what I would say is that the way a person would deal with that, if you were a person from Vermont, I don't believe issues carry permits, if
That's
I
right.
recall correctly. So,
really?
So, for example, if you were a resident of Vermont who wanted to travel to Michigan and carry a weapon, what you would want to do is obtain a non-resident permit from another state. So New Hampshire will issue those for like $100, a Florida non-resident permit. I don't know what the fee is, but that is about as close as you can get to a nationwide concealed carry permit, the Florida permit.
So, Florida's a pain in the butt. I grew up down there, and when I turned 21, my dad gave me a pistol for my birthday and encouraged me to go and get the concealed carry permit, which I went and looked into it. I got the packet of information about it from the police department. And it was like a manila folder full of paperwork, and I was just like, screw this. I am not interested in jumping through whatever ridiculous hoops. I didn't even look through the damn thing. I was like, the hell with this. Not going to even start this process. But in New Hampshire, it's like, what, a form or something like that?
Yeah, it's a pretty short form. I've heard that they added something to it since I got my permit, and there was a big uproar about that. But when I did it, it was real easy. I just filled out this, you know, one-page thing. I handed it to the town clerk. They are required to give it to me within 2 weeks. They actually forgot about it, and I called them up, and I said, well, you know, you're past the two-week mark. Am I going to have to take you to court? And they said, no. Stop by tomorrow, and we'll give you your carry permit. And it was basically rubber stamped the next day.
So, James, let's go back to your original point. You were calling to say that you've started doing some activism in your area. You do intend to move to New Hampshire as part of the Free State Project, which is great news, and people who love liberty really should consider moving to New Hampshire, whether it's part of the Free State Project or the Shire Society. For instance, at shiresociety.com, you've started a Liberty on the Rocks group. Now, that's basically kind of like a social club, right? Like people going and drinking together?
I'm starting it. It hasn't started yet. It's just, I've initially put in the request. I'm just waiting for the phone call back. And they offer a ton of support based
oh, really?
On what I see, you know, helping you set up websites. Actually, I watched Mark do an interview with the founder, and that actually is what got me to say, hey, I want to do this.
Cool.
So that's why.
How are you going to promote it? How are you going to get the word out to presumably other libertarians in the region that this thing exists? What's the way to do that?
Well, a lot of it is word of mouth. They also give you the resources to find liberty-minded people.
Oh, really? Oh, good.
Just reading their site, I mean, they pretty much do everything for you. They set up a website, give you an email address, and give you all the resources to go out and start this group. And it just seemed like something I could do. You know, I still love this town. It's a pretty town. I'll be back to visit quite often, but, you know, the government's just too big here in Michigan, you know, and I want to go somewhere where I can live free. And
you can't live free in New Hampshire, but you can be freer in some ways.
Yeah, have more liberty, and a place where, you know, I'm surrounded by more activists. But I figured at the very least, you know, leave a little nugget behind, maybe get something going. My best friend's going to be helping me. He's also a libertarian. Although he's not going to New Hampshire, but he's supporting me.
Cool, man. And that's a good way to kind of maybe stir up some extra support for the Free State Project. Once you get your Liberty on the Rocks group going and there are several people showing up to these meetings, then it'd be a good time to have, you know, a Free State Project presentation be given to these folks, because there's no future for freedom
They're
in those
eligible.
Places. Hey, thanks, James, for your call tonight. Good luck. James was listening via TuneIn, by the way. So we mentioned earlier and didn't really expound on this, Chris Cantwell. You've got a date coming up, maybe, with a Keene police officer, a man.
Yeah, I.
What?
That's so funny the way you put this. So after the incident, Sergeant Tenney of the Keene Police Department asked me to email him the video of the incident. They did not even take my phone from me. They were like, "Hey, can you email me that evidence when you get
That's
a chance?"
Awesome.
Right? And so I did email it to him. And when I said, "Look, can I take you gentlemen out to lunch or something to thank you for what you did?" And they said, "Well, we shouldn't be accepting gratuities."
Not only they shouldn't, they won't.
Right.
It's their policy to not accept benefits from outside, you know, from the public. They won't take
money.
It's
a smart policy, and more police departments should adopt it.
Yeah, so I said to him, I said, look, I wouldn't want to create any sort of financial impropriety here, but, you know, buy your own if you must, but let us break bread nonetheless. And he said that he was open to doing that. Now, I haven't set a time for it, whether or not it actually happens, we shall see.
And he was real cool about it. I mean, like, you forwarded me some of the emails, and the back and forth was really, you know, courteous.
Yeah.
And respectful, and he seemed to think that it would benefit. You thought it would benefit both of you, and he agreed that it would benefit both sides, if you will, if you guys got together and had a conversation.
Yeah, I sort of want to assure these people that I am not stupid or crazy, right? I mean, this is terribly unlikely to be my last encounter with the Keene Police Department, and I am an armed man who talks about very controversial things. If they are just going by what a cartoon character is saying on a website about Christopher Cantwell, and they come up and they think that he's a threat to their safety, you know, I could end up dead. So I think it'd be a good thing for us to sort of discuss our differences.
I mean, does this go against one of the rules of, you know, don't talk to the police? You're going to go talk to the police.
In some ways, I guess there are those who could accuse me of that. However,
well, the rules, I feel like the rules don't apply in the same way in Keene, New Hampshire, because here we're not talking about a situation on the streets with people, you know, strange officers in, that you don't know, that you've never encountered before. We're talking about somebody that you have met before. You've met Tenney right. before in another circumstance. And, you know, this is not your first time dealing with this individual. And he's a human being, you know. And I think that's one of the things that I learned real quick here in Keene was that these guys, you know, again, they're doing some things I disagree with. I would like them to end the war on drugs and stop enforcing victimless crime laws. But otherwise, I think a lot of them really, you know, they're good. They're, I think, good people at heart who did get in for the right reasons. I think a lot of them did. I'm not going to say all of them did. I'm not going to pass judgment on all of them here. But, you know, having been able to touch base with them and talk to them like people, I think has been really helpful. For
me. I am not in the habit of possessing drugs. For all, you know, for all my hatred of the state, I tend to obey its laws, right? Mm-hmm. And so I don't really, I don't have anything to fear from the police as far as their regular law enforcement activity goes, right? I don't victimize people. I don't do drugs. I don't, you know, worry about, you know, being arrested for anything, really. So if I'm going to go and have a conversation with a guy and sort of assure him that I am not some violent lunatic with a gun, you know, that's probably in both of our best interests, because I don't think that they are going to be benefited by having that opinion of me either.
Now, this is good police work on their part, too. If they have somebody in town that they, you know, they're likely to come in contact with, that they, you know, may disagree with on some issues or whatever, they should be having conversations with people like that. They should be having conversations with the citizenry. And good police officers, for that matter, are going out and getting in contact with, you know, gang members and mm-hmm. things like that. These are the things that they should be doing. So, yeah, I mean, they should be. They should be talking to people.
Follow the latest over at ChristopherCantwell.com. And, of course, we'll have you back here on Free Talk Live sooner rather than later. And also, you are welcome to join us, not now, but tomorrow night. In between now and then, you can join us online at FreeTalkLive.com. And again, ChristopherCantwell.com. Go check out his video if you haven't seen it yet.
Hi, I'm Derek J. To me, an activist's calling is to actively work to advance a cause. The cause for which I work is personal freedom. I believe my life is best when I engage in voluntary interactions and self-government. I reject the idea that anyone else has a higher claim to my life or my body than I do. I see people who call themselves the government as a threat to my personal freedom. I realize you may feel differently, but my relationship with the people who call themselves the government is completely involuntary. If Starbucks used some of its money to drop bombs, I wouldn't shop there. So why would I support the American Empire? The Empire does not require my consent.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. That's victimlesscrimespree.com.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark, at freetalklive.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
Cop Block Radio is up next, live after the news, on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
from Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world. This is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Wednesday, May 13th, 2015. Silver is trading at $16.95 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,203 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $245. Antiwar.com reports 6 weeks into their aerial campaign, and after 48 hours of severe escalation, Saudi Arabia has announced a temporary halt to their airstrikes against Yemen, the beginning of what they say will be a five-day humanitarian pause. There is skepticism, but also a lot of hope among Yemeni civilians who are hoping their cities won't be bombed over the next few days, and hoping even more that the Saudi naval blockade will begin allowing humanitarian aid into the country. While fighting picked up, particularly along the border in the hours leading up to the 11 p.m. deadline, residents of Yemeni cities have reported no incidents in the first couple of hours since. Saudi military commanders say that despite the pause, they will continue overflights of Yemen for surveillance purposes and will resume strikes if they believe the Houthis are violating the terms of the deal, which includes that none of their troops move for the next 5 days. For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. UPI reports a 7.3 magnitude earthquake struck Nepal on Tuesday, just weeks after another earthquake devastated parts of the nation and killed more than 8,000 people. At least 37 people were killed and more than 1,000 injured in the town of Chatara by the latest earthquake. At least 17 also died in India and one in Tibet. A 6.3 magnitude aftershock followed shortly after Tuesday's quake. The earthquake occurred about 50 miles east of Kathmandu, the country's capital. The latest quake struck at a depth of 9 miles, and Nepal is still recovering from the magnitude 7.8 earthquake that struck the central part of the country on April 25th, leading to thousands of deaths and 17,000 injured. The effects of the latest quake were felt in Kathmandu, but there were no reports of significant damage there. The Save the Children charity said teams were assessing the impact on buildings that had already been damaged and told USA Today, "It's a terrifying time for the hundreds of thousands of children and families who lost everything in the April 25th earthquake." Meanwhile, a U.S. Marines helicopter conducted disaster relief missions in Nepal went missing on Tuesday. ExpressCoin is the best choice for buying Bitcoin, Litecoin, Dogecoin, and more. ExpressCoin prides themselves on their customer service, so much so that the back end on the website should allow them to be even more focused on your needs. Get your cryptocurrencies with money order, check, wire transfer, or cash deposit. Get started at expresscoin.fppradio.com. That's expresscoin.fppradio.com. Reuters reports Texas on Tuesday executed a man convicted of murdering his girlfriend, her mother, and grandfather in their Houston home in 2002 as he took revenge on the family for trying to cut off his relationship with the daughter. Derek Charles was announced dead at 6:36 p.m. Central Time after receiving a lethal injection at the state's death chamber in Huntsville, according to prison officials. Charles, who strangled all three, was the 525th inmate executed in Texas since the U.S. Supreme Court reinstated the death penalty in 1976, with the state accounting for 37% of all executions in the country during the time. The U.S. Supreme Court denied a petition seeking to halt the execution. Lawyers for Charles had argued that he was mentally incompetent and could not legally be subject to capital punishment. At the time of the crime, Charles was 19 and out on parole for burglary. Prosecutors said he sought revenge on Brenda Bennett because she was trying to stop her underage daughter, Maisha, from having sex with Charles. Charles hid in the family home and first beat Obie Bennett with a lamp and trophies. The grandfather was found in the kitchen with an electrical cord around his neck, according to prosecutors and the Texas Attorney General. He then waited for Brenda and Maisha to come home. When they arrived, he bound and gagged them. According to prosecutors, he killed Maisha and sexually assaulted and strangled her mother. He pled guilty to the crime and was later sentenced to death. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
The Onion looks back at This Week in History. On July 17, 1980, Ronald Reagan accepted the nomination for president at the Republican National Convention in Detroit and delivered a speech in which he boldly promised that during a